Shining. I like $1 million deals. Where's my pen? Bitch, I'm signing. I like those Balenciagas, the ones that look like socks. I like going to the Tula. I put rocks all in my watch. I like texts from my exes when they want a second chance. I like proving wrong. I do what they say I can. They call me Cardi, Cardi, banging body, spicy mommy, hot tamale, hotter than a Somali. Hop up the stoop, jump in the coop. Big dip on top of the roof. Flexing on as hard as I can. Eating halal, driving a Lamb. So that bitch, I'm sorry though. Got my coins like Mario. Yeah, they call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio. Diamond District in the chain. Certified, you know I'm gang, 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 gang. Drop the top and blow the brand. Oh, he's so handsome, what's his name?
Chambean, chambean, pero no jalan. Tú compras todas las Yolambo, a mí me las regalan. I spend in the club, what you have in the bank. This is the new religion bank, el latino gang. Está toda servieta, pero es que en el closet tengo mucha grasa. Ya mudé la Gucci pa' dentro de casa, yeah. A ti no te conoce ni en plaza. El diablo me llama, pero Jesucristo me abraza. Guerrero como Eddie, que viva la raza, yeah. Me gustan boricua, me gustan cubana. Me gusta el acento de la colombiana. Como me ve el culo la dominicana. Lo rico que me chinga la venezolana. Andamos activos, perico, pim, pim. Billetes de 100 en el maletín. Que retumbe el bajo y Valentín, yeah. Aquí prohibido amar, dile Charitín. Que per pico le tengo claritín. Yo llego a la disco y se forma el motín.
Diamond District in the chain.
Welcome to another installment of Hockey Night in Fredonia here at Steel Hall, a very packed Steel Hall, as it is Pink the Rink night. I'm Josh Schmidt, alongside me, Kevin Syracuse. You're listening to WDVL 89.5, the Inferno, and WCVF 88.9, the Voice. Fredonia taking on the Potsdam Bears tonight in another Pink the Rink installment, as we always see at the end of the year. Real packed house tonight.
Yeah. As it always is for Pink the Rink Night, this is the 14th year of having this game, and in 14 years they have raised $91,000 for breast cancer awareness. We got another great crowd here as we are about a minute and a half from face-off here. Fredonia's coming off of a huge win last night over Plattsburgh, 5-0. Jacob, I was going to say Haynes had two, but I'm blanking. Who had Jasper. Jasper Korak on Barley had two. Haynes had one. Hugo Gamache had his first collegiate goal.
And we know
Tommy Martin had the other.
And we know Anton Rosen coming back from his little injury bout he had there with a shutout in his first game back. He'll get the start again tonight up against his adversary will be Pagluka at the other end. Puck about to be dropped here as Cork and Barley's out to take it for Fredonia. Wins it back into his own zone. Back to Manley. Manley works it up the boards. Cross ice now to Tracy. Tracy breaking into the Potsdam zone. Broken apart there by Potsdam. Worked through the neutral zone. Manley intercepts. Over to Gamache. Gamache works it up. Comes Tracy now breaking in with Haynes. Haynes down low behind the Potsdam net. Broken up by Potsdam. Number 13, Vincent Guimond. Worked out now by Potsdam. Farrell breaking in, shoots high and wide. Kane picks it up along his bench. Clears it out of the zone. Fredonia and Potsdam will make their first changes of the game. Ventnor working it up now for Potsdam. Dumps it in. Picked up down low by McCabe. He's bothered in there by Salau. Kept in by Potsdam. Worked down low out in front, and nobody can get onto it. Salau has it now for Potsdam. Works it down low. Back up to the point for Ventnor. Ventnor battles in there with Dunner. Now it's down low in the Fredonia zone. Brought away by Gamache. Gamache works it up by his own bench. It's cleared through the neutral zone and right back in by Potsdam. Fredonia trying to work it out of their own zone here. Here's McCabe working along the boards. Potsdam keeps it in though. Back to point for Venter. Venter kicking the shot. Another shot comes down and Rosen makes the glove save. Quick shot there from MacArthur. Right in the middle with a pass from Venter.
Well, Josh, you were talking about Anton Rosen. He had a 32-save shutout last night in his first game back in a couple of months. He was out due to concussions, and he looked great last night.
We didn't see him at all over the break or even a couple games before the break, and it's great to see him come back and bounce back from an injury like that. Fredonia trying to work it out of their own zone now. Here's Martin. Martin broken up by Potsdam. Potsdam keeps it in down low, trying to work it in front of the net. Fredonia almost clears. Now they have it behind their own net. Clear out of the zone, and it will be icing. It's cleared there out of the Fredonia zone. They were pressured for quite a bit there, but now they won't get a change. So bet Fredonia's trying to get a change here with a few tired guys out there. But Potsdam's looking to pounce here. Potsdam wins the draw back to the point, but it goes all the way down the ice, and this will not be icing. Fredonia gets the much-needed change. And that'll be icing the other way now as Potsdam tried to make a quick breakout pass up the boards. It didn't connect. And now Fredonia gets a chance on the offensive zone draw.
Taking a look at the standings now. So Potsdam comes into tonight as the fifth-place seed. Last night they were in seventh, so that just kind of shows how tight it is. Fredonia's last with 6 points, and Cortland holds the Cortland and Morrisville are tied for that sixth and final playoff spot with 10 points. So Fredonia's 4 games back with 5 to play, including tonight's game.
Right.
So
big game for Fredonia tonight. Here comes Potsdam working out the other way. Here's a 3-on-2 now. Potsdam breaking in, shot on Rosen, and he holds on to the rebound there. Shot came from number 8, Brett Horn. Almost a dangerous situation there for Fredonia, but Rosen makes sure to gobble that one up. You were saying, Kevin?
Yeah, so Fredonia is 5-9-6 overall, 2-7-2 in the conference. So they have 6 points. And Potsdam comes into tonight's game. They're only 6-15-1 overall, but they have a lot of – they're 5-8-1 in conference play. So that's why they are the fifth-place seed. So, honestly, record-wise, these teams are you know, relatively similar. I'm trying to figure out how they've played so many games already. Unless
Potsdam and Fredonia scrumming at
typo.
The line. Fredonia has it now in their own corner, trying to work it up here. Here's Cork and Barley through the neutral zone. Everybody had to reset their offsides, and Cork and Barley dumps it in, takes a weird hop off the boards, goes behind the Potsdam net. Collected in behind the boards. Here's Richardson. Works it up to Guimond. Now works through the neutral zone. Here comes Young. Young centers it. Rosen steers it away. Haynes trying to break up the play along the boards. 4 players coming together there as Potsdam kills with a puck. Shot from the point and goes wide. No worries for Rosen there. Venter puts it down low. Potsdam making a change here as Fredonia looks to break out of their own zone, and they do. Potsdam will intercept and come right back though. Shot from the point there from number 4, Terranova. It's down in Fredonia's corner. Cork and Barley now with puck for Fredonia. Works it up the wall by his bench. Here comes Dunner breaking in, and he can't break through the two defenders. Potsdam working back the other way. Here's a 4-on-2 possibly. Terranova trying to make the move on and can't get there, but Rosen has to.
Oh,
Rosen
wow.
Makes a dribbling save from the shot from the point.
That was.
Loses his stick and almost.
About
almost
a footer. Yeah, foot or two away from crossing that line.
I'd say inches. That was great awareness by Rosen there. Feels it go through his pads and just spins around and knocks it away, but he holds on to it too, so that's good for him. see a couple Potsdam guys crashing the net there, too. You bet Rosen doesn't want to take another shot to the head this late in the season. Or at any time, for that matter. Potsdam wins the draw now. Scramble for the puck here as Potsdam comes up with it down low behind the Fredonia net. There's Panzica looking in down low. Fredonia comes up with it now, trying to clear it out of the zone, and they do. Dunner trying to get free. He can. He centers it, and nobody home for Fredonia. Dunner made an excellent move around two defenders there. Here comes Potsdam the other way in a 3-on-2. Potsdam puts it down on Rosen. Rosen save, rebound, and cleared away by Fredonia. Held in at the neutral zone by Potsdam. They dump it in to make a change. Fredonia changes as well. Fredonia breaking out behind their own net now. Loses the puck to the neutral zone, and Potsdam will dump it back in. Rosen comes out to collect it. Misses the puck, though. Ryder has it along the boards now. Ryder trying to get past the Potsdam defender. Can't do it. Now he does. Ryder working through the neutral zone here. He's got some help in Letmanski. Ryder and Letmanski coming in. Ryder shoots, and it's deflected up high and wide and out into the netting.
You know, Josh, when I was saying a couple minutes ago about the standings, I was like, man, it looked like Potsdam's played so many more games. I was like, they have more tournament games? But the thing was, the main difference is Fredonia's been in a lot of tight games. Those games have ended in ties. They have 6 ties this year. Potsdam right. only has 1. So they have 15 losses, only 1 tie. Fredonia 9 losses, 6 ties.
Right, so they have the same amount of games.
So I think Potsdam still has them by a couple. But the point is, you know, they're pretty relative teams, or pretty similar teams here.
Right. Blitz trying to work it through the neutral zone now. Can't connect in the pass. McCabe picks up the loose puck, and now here comes Potsdam the other way. Shot blocked by Blitz. Right in the knee there. Block from Blitz there. Here's McCabe working up by his own bench. Potsdam intercepts. Potsdam trying to work it in front of the net, and Farrell can't find it and get a shot on, but Haynes has it now for Fredonia. Going through the neutral zone. Up to Tracy. Tracy in on goal. Shoots off the post. Farrell battering for it now for Potsdam. Tracy and Haynes on him. Haynes breaks away. Free break. Beautiful move there by Haynes, and a penalty coming up here to Potsdam. Potsdam kind of gets control of it.
Is that Fredonia?
No, it's going to be a Potsdam penalty, I believe. But I didn't think they
had
control
of it. Well, Haynes had the puck when they blew it.
Right, but the Potsdam player did touch the puck up. I didn't look like clear, you know, possession, but Potsdam will be going to the penalty kill here, and Fredonia will get their first power play of the night. And it's pizza time, first one of the night. Somebody's holding up a baby for the pizza.
So Fredonia goes back on the power play where they were 2 for 5 last night.
See if they can keep those power play numbers going. We see the pink towels of Fredonia twirling around here tonight. Potsdam wins the draw in their own zone. Trying to clear it out. Tracy keeps it in at the point. Tracy down low to Kirbis. Kirbis down low to Haynes. Potsdam trying to clear it out. Held in by Manley. No, taken away by Potsdam. Here comes Potsdam away now on one-on-one. Tries to break in. Rosen steers it away, and good back check there from Kirbis to take the puck into the corner. Haynes working it out now with three of his teammates. Breaking through the neutral zone here. Manley dumps it in. Cork and Barley into Chase. Him and Clark go together into the boards. Comes out in front. Shot from Manley off the post again. Off the corner piece of the post that time. 2 posts already for Fredonia tonight. Beautiful play by Kirbis to get it out in front to Manley, but just can't find the top corner.
So Fredonia still has yet to get a shot on net.
Technically, yes.
A couple off the post here. Potsdam has 7 shots. Fredonia technically has 0.
Right. But Fredonia has clearly quite a few more chances. Potsdam wins the draw in their own zone now. Trying to ring it around the board and clear it out. Held in there by Fredonia defense. Shot on net. And
first one.
Sucked in by Pagluka.
That was minutes. Tommy Martin.
Yep, it was Tommy Martin. We know him and Manley both combined for a heck of a shot. But a minute 16 to go on the power play here for Fredonia to the right of Pagluka. Ryder is tossed from the circle, and Dunner will step in. He'll be taking face-off against Terranova. Terranova wins the draw into the corner. Benter collects and dumps it out. Gamache is there to collect in neutral zone. Over to Martin. Martin cross-ice flip to Dunner. And Benter is quick on him there. And Potsdam clears it this time. It's number 24, Paul Machura, gives chase. Martin's right on him, but Martin gets it back to his partner, Gamache, and Gamache will work it out now out of the Fredonia zone. Here comes Gamache. Gamache dumps it in. Ooh, and it will be icing. Gamache didn't cross center line there, so it'll come back down to Fredonia's zone with 41 seconds to go on the power play here.
Yeah, so Fredonia generating one shot on net here. Couple off the pipe.
Three shots on net.
41 seconds left in this man advantage.
Solao taking the draw for Potsdam here. Fredonia wins the draw back in their own zone. Whitman hits it over to Gamache. Gamache tries to work it up. Can't connect. Dunner intercepts it now. Here comes Dunner. Dunner shoots. Deflects out of play. Nice block there by Cruikshank. Knocks it into the netting.
Now, another thing about last night's game, Fredonia killed off three penalties in the first period.
Right.
9 minutes. One was a five-minute major, and then the other two were just normal two-minute penalties.
Right, the whole game they were down Kirbis. Back to the point now is Manley. Manley, we're going to down low. Manley back with it now. Over to Tracy. Tracy has it. Back to Manley. Manley over to Cork and Barley. Down low. Cork and Barley has it back now and can't get a shot on that. Here, Gona. And behind into the corner now is Fredonia. Up to the point to Manley. Manley with a shot on goal. Rebound out in front. Fredonia can't bury it. Cork and Barley has it now for Fredonia. Penalty expires. Shot on net turned away by Pegluka. Haynes trying to take it away now. Here comes Solao the other way. Looks it up to Terranova. Terranova dumps it in and Potsdam goes off for a change. McCabe works it up the boards with a little kicking motion there. Letmanski in, giving chase to it. And Potsdam recollects in their own zone. Big hit after the play there from Tyler Ryder. Ryder has it now behind the Potsdam net. He's pestered there by Richardson. Richardson able to get it to his teammate, but they can't clear. Richardson has it back now for Potsdam. Glitter of the boards to Solao. He takes it behind his own net. He leaves it there.
Kind of quiet in here so far.
Right. All the people in here, I mean, it could be louder. Here comes Venter working through the neutral zone for Potsdam. Venter dumps it in. Rosen out to collect it. Rosen has a man on him. Farrell almost took the puck away from him there, but Fredonia holds firm. Blitz has the puck now, working it up by his bench. Intercepted by Farrell out in front. Cleared away by McCabe there. Fredonia trying to clear it out of their own zone. Under a lot of pressure here from Potsdam. Clue over to Blitz. Blitz up the boards to Letmanski. Letmanski can't get it through neutral ice, and Potsdam comes right back. Here's Farrell with a shot on net. Rosen turns it into the corner. Farrell with behind the net. Puts it out in front. Rosen with the save on the post. Fredonia has it now and just clears it. It might not. It won't go all the way for icing. Right on Pegluka. He has to steer it into the corner now. Venter. Up the wing. Intercepted by Gamache. Gamache is just, I believe it was, not sure who was offside there. Gamache was obviously onside, but it must have been somebody coming out of the zone.
I think it was Kirbis.
Yeah.
Just by a hair.
Kirbis wins the draw. Gamache dumps it in. Potsdam has it behind their own net. Bloom rings it around the boards. Fredonia has the neutral zone now. Oh, somebody took a puck to the face there as Martin tried to clear it, or Manley tried to clear it into Potsdam's zone. I believe it was Ben Thompson of Potsdam took Martin's clearing attempt right to the dome. And that's why you wear cages, but he looks to be in quite a bit of pain over there on the bench. I'll have to keep an eye on him, see if he comes back to the game here. We wish him the best. Draw comes down to Fredonia's zone now to the left of Rosen. Dunner wins the draw. Back into his own corner. Manley puts it up the boards. Demikopoulos can't get it out though. Manley has it back here. Manley tries to find Dunner. Dunner puts it back down low to Gamache. Can't find Demikopoulos there as Potsdam recollects in the neutral zone. Dumps it in on just to the left of Rosen. Manley battling in down low there with Penzeca. Shot from the point, shot wide, Rosen. Shot again from the point, blocked by Fredonia. Here comes Fredonia the other way, 3-on-2. Cork and Barley breaking in, puts it to hands to Tracy. Tracy shoots and Peg Luka makes a save. Here comes Potsdam back the other way, 2-on-2 for Potsdam. Putting the moves on, backhand shot, Rosen makes a save. Rebound cleared away by Fredonia. Cork and Barley trying to clear it in now. Clark intercepts it and I'm not sure what the call is here. I think it might be a penalty. Did you catch what happened there?
No, I don't think there's going to, are they talking about a penalty now?
I'm not sure because the ref clearly pointed to Fredonia's zone, but.
Did he call it offsides?
Might have been, oh, he might have thought it was a deliberate offside, so the play was going to go back to Fredonia's blue line.
Yeah, so no penalty. It must have been offsides then.
Right, right. Potsdam wins the draw now into their own zone. Richardson working up the wing here. Dumps it in far side. Claire in to chase it, but Fredonia clears it. Fredonia has it in front of their own net now. It's back in Potsdam zone. Up to Terranova. Terranova trying to work it up the boards to Claire. Claire works it in to Solau.
Ooh, but I think he hit the ref there.
Ref got hit with the puck there, yeah. But Manskeev's chase after this one, and but the Potsdam defenseman just go D to D, and here comes Potsdam through the neutral zone. Cleared away by Rosen there. A shot from Claire as Rosen clears it into the corner. Back to the point now for Potsdam. Shot from the point blocked away by Fredonia. Potsdam keeps it in the zone, puts it down in the corner, blitz in after it with Solau. Battle in the corner there, 3 Fredonia Blue Devils against Solau, and Fredonia comes up with it. Fredonia has it along the boards, trying to get the blitz. Blitz to McCabe. McCabe trying to clear it, and it will not clear. Popped out into the center there for Fredonia, but Fredonia's able to clear that one. But it'll go too far for icing. Fredonia won't get a change. You can tell they wanted one there, but let us tough it out for a little bit longer. 7:45 left in the first period. 0-0 is your score. You're just joining us.
12-5 shots in favor of Potsdam.
Should be 12-7.
Okay. All right, we'll just start adding 2 on every time now. So our live stats here say 5. I'll just add the 2 before I before I say the shots from now on.
Third into the Potsdam zone. Fredonia gets off to make a change. Here comes Venter the other way. Passes it to nobody, and Kierbus intercepts, dumps it back into the Potsdam zone. Here comes Dimakopoulos chasing Venter. Dimakopoulos goes into the corner. Funny angle. Potsdam working through the neutral zone now. No icing. Rosen comes out to collect it and just clears it off the boards. Fredonia trying to get it from their goalie here, and Potsdam gets a shot on net. Doesn't make anything of it, though, as it goes back to the neutral zone for Venter. Venter. Download a horn, and Dimakopoulos intercepts here. Dimakopoulos dumps it in right on Peg Luka, and he's going to play it right to his D-man, Clark. Clark up the boards, but MacArthur loses his footing there, and Fredonia collects it in their own zone. Here's Gamache now. Trying to work it up to Tracy. Can't do it. Comes Potsdam the other way. Puts it in front of the net. Off to nobody. Ooh, Haynes awkwardly into the boards there. He almost did a split in the boards. And Potsdam out in front. Has 2 men. Can't get the shot off. Clark works it down low for Potsdam. Behind the Fredonia net. Out in front. Back to the point. Cruikshank can't keep it in. Fredonia trying to get some puck possession here. Here comes Haynes through the neutral zone. Into the Potsdam end. Down in the corner as Potsdam takes it back. Kept in at the point. Here comes Clark the other way for Potsdam.
Under 6 to go here.
Cleared all the way down the zone, and Johnson will have to take chase to it. And out in front for Potsdam and blocked away. Rebound. Rosen trying to find another kick save from Rosen. Fredonia trying to clear it away for their goaltender here as he made 2-3 good saves there for Fredonia right out in front as Potsdam had 3 great chances. Right in front of the net. Potsdam in their own end now, trying to work it back out and try to work some magic through the neutral zone. Here comes Young. Puts a shot on. Rosen turns it aside, down into the corner. Farrell trying to work it back out in front, rings it around the boards. Letmanski has it now. To McCabe. Can't find Ryder, but Ryder will give chase to it right against Richardson. Ryder and Richardson going in at it behind Potsdam's net. Richardson puts it off to Leith. Leith will hold it behind his own net. Potsdam and Fredonia both are changing. Leith works it out now. Up to Salau. Drops it off to Richardson. Richardson trying to put the moves on Kirbis there. Rosen gloves it down, but can't hold on to it. His blitz has to clear it into the corner. McCabe has behind his own net. Over to Dunner. Dunner, cross-ice pass right in front of his own net to Blitz, and Blitz is able to corral that one. Puts the puck off the linesman, though, and they have to reset in their own zone.
It's the second time that's happened. They tried clearing off the boards, but they cleared off the ref.
Right, here comes Potsdam the other way. Potsdam trying to break in. Four Devils swarm that player, and can't get the shot off as Fredonia clears. Here comes Potsdam again. Terranova trying to break in. Can't get through the Fredonia pinch there. Three Devils just surrounded Terranova. It will be another icing against Fredonia here. As I think it was McCabe tried to work it up the boards, but couldn't find anybody in particular, and it'll go all the way back down for icing. Rosen skating over to the bench right now. See what's going on with him there. Maybe trying to stall a little bit for his teammates, but we'll have to wait and see.
4:14 left in the first period here. Shots 13-8. I added the two this time.
You're able to do math, I see. Rosen's still at the bench now, and he's talking to the trainer and the ref at the same time. I can't tell what's going on with him, but looks like he's going to stay. As he skates back to his net. Might have been trying to kill a little time for his teammates there off that icing. But nonetheless, Rosen stays in the net, and face-offs to his left. Corcabarley taking the draw here against MacArthur. Fredonia wins it. Trying to clear it out of the zone to Dunner. Dunner along the boards, can't get it. Finally clears out of the zone, though, as Potsdam can't control it. Goes all the way back to their own end. Clark has it now. Brings it around the boards to number 11 there, Bloom. Corcabarley hits him, and here comes Tracy and Haynes the other way. Haynes has it in front of the net, can't get the shot off. Still has the puck, shoots. Pagluka makes the save, and no one can pick up the rebound. Here comes Bloom the other way for Potsdam. Bloom trying to break in, trying to put the moves on Gamache. Gamache slows him down. Corcabarley with the puck now right in front of Rosen. Corcabarley looks up to Haynes. Haynes dumps it in, goes off for a change. Tracy in to chase it for Fredonia. Richardson picks it up for Potsdam. Richardson working out of his own zone through the middle. Puts it up, and that'll be just offside. It looks like Young was offside there for Potsdam.
You know, Josh, the simplest way I can describe this game right now, neither team is doing anything bad, but neither team is doing anything good.
It's a very mediocre game
at
this point.
It's just very, very neutral here.
Right.
It's like the most even game so far that we could see here.
Right. I mean, aside from shots, you'd think that, two people get tied up in the draw there. And they go at each other a little bit. I think that's Farrell and Ryder. We'll see if that continues throughout the night. Fredonia has it in their own zone. Pestered there by Farrell. Put back up to the point here. Ooh, high check there from Ryder again. Richardson has it at the point now for Potsdam. Brings it in down low. Put out in front for nobody in particular for Potsdam. And Farrell's down in low with Martin. Fredonia's trying to clear, and puck goes out. Look out there down in the front row. Puck comes out of the rink, rather. And draw will stay in Fredonia's zone to Rosen's right.
Yeah, you know, there have been a few loose pucks in front of the net, you know, a couple scraps in front of the net, a couple shots went off the post. Fredonia's on the power play.
Right.
So if you want to classify that as maybe a little exciting, you know, you can. But other than that, everything's been pretty neutral here.
Right. Fredonia wins the draw, working out of their own zone here. Kirbis in to chase it. Potsdam trying to pass it up through the neutral zone, and nobody will get it, but it won't go far enough for icing as Blitz collects it for Fredonia. Blitz works up the boards. Stolen away there by Potsdam, and oh, look out on the bench. Oh, nope, not going to go on the bench this time. Goes all the way down, but no icing as Potsdam collects in their own zone. Here's Venter. Venter tries to work through the middle. Haynes intercepts it. They're onside, but they can't get in. Dunner with it now. Dunner to Haynes. Haynes trying to break through the two defensemen. Haynes is broken in. Oh, and he can't finish it. Dangles around two Potsdam defenders and can't get his stick on the puck. Here's Venter now behind his own net. Passes it off to Terranova. Intercepted by Fredonia. Has it behind the Potsdam net now. Here's Tracy. Tracy down to Cork and Barley. To Haynes. Cork and Barley and Haynes trying to work behind the net here. Salau trying to break out now for Potsdam. Breaks it out through the neutral zone to Claire. Claire with a shot on net. Blocked away. Rosen will cover up on that one. But almost a brilliant move there from Jacob Haynes around those two Potsdam defenders.
Yeah, that was a real nice dangle from Jacob Haynes. And he's their leading scorer this year. He has 26 points.
26, yeah.
He had his 11th goal last night. Him and Charlie Manley were tied for the team lead with 10. And then Haynes had his team leading 11th goal last night against Plattsburgh.
Haynes in 18 games has 11 goals and 13 points. Probably one of his best years, I would think, with numbers like that. Potsdam wins the draw, keeps it in Fredonia's zone, behind the Fredonia net. Scrum ensues with four players back there. McCabe comes up with the puck for Fredonia, works it out. Letmanski going after it now for Fredonia with Clark. Clark has it for Potsdam now. Potsdam trying to break out here. Can't make the pass connect as Fredonia collects it back in their own zone. There's Ryder in the neutral zone. Ryder dumps it in. Letmanski gives chase to it with Clark. Letmanski and Clark come together along the boards. And Clark will have it behind his own net now. Clark up the horn. Last minute play in the period as Potsdam's trying to break in here. Broken up by Fredonia. Kamash dumps it to the neutral zone. And Richardson will collect now for Potsdam. Richardson can't pass anybody. And Blitz will dump it just too far for icing. And we have 47.9 seconds to go here in the first period.
Yeah, so Jacob Haynes has 11 goals, 15 assists for a team-leading 26 points. Victor Tracy is their second-leading scorer, 5 goals, 17 assists with 22 points. And Jasper Corrigan Barley, Charlie Manley, and Ethan Kerbis round out the top five.
We'd also like to note that's 89 points in 90 career games for Jacob Haynes. Stellar career here at Fredonia, and it's not done yet. Here comes Fredonia breaking out of their own zone now. Kalu works it up and tries to get it to Demakopoulos, but he can't stay onside as the draw will come just outside of the Potsdam zone with 39.4 seconds to go here. 0-0 between Potsdam and Fredonia here at Steel Hall on Pink the Rink night.
Fredonia wearing their pink uniforms with different names on the back, so right. It makes it a little harder for us to distinguish who they are.
You notice the one really cool one, though, is Letmanski has his own name on the back. So Cork and Barley now with the Potsdam behind the Potsdam net. Trying to work it around with Haynes and Tracy. Is Haynes tied up behind the net, and Cork and Barley comes in to help, but he gets tied up behind the net as well. Four bodies in there as there's 20 seconds remaining, ticking away behind the Potsdam net. Farrell comes in now to collect it for Potsdam as he clears it up through the neutral zone, and McCabe collects now for Fredonia. McCabe loses his stick, tries to kick it through the neutral zone, playing a little soccer there. Here comes Potsdam the other way, though, as McCabe doesn't have a stick. Cork and Barley cleared it into the corner, and that'll actually see out time. I didn't realize how little time was left. As McCabe will bury it in the corner, and we'll head to intermission. So we'll be back in a little while with our intermission report. For now, enjoy some music. It's 0-0, Fredonia and Potsdam here on Pink the Rink Night. You've been listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia on WDVL 89.5 The Inferno and WCBF 88.9 The Voice. Stay tuned.
I want to know who my representing in here tonight. Hold on.
Explain myself. You said you care for me, Louisiana. Murder on the beat. Something for y'all to cut up to, you know. Yeah. Everybody get your roll on. I know shorty and she doesn't want no slow song. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let the thing loose, girl, in so long. You been inside, know you like to lay low. I been peeping what you bringin' to the table. Working hard, girl, everything paid for. First
your phone out, gotta hit them angles. With your phone out, snapping like you Fabo. And you showing off, but it's alright. And you showing off, but it's alright. It's a short life. Without a follow, without a mention, you really piping up on these. You gotta be nice for what to these? I understand. You got 100 bands, you got a baby Benz, you got some bad friends. High school pics, you was even bad then. You ain't stressing off no lover in the past tense. You already had them. Work at 8 a.m., finish round 5. All down, you don't see them outside. Yeah, they don't really be the same offline. You know dog days, you know hard times. Time for the last month. Saturday, call the girls, get them gassed up. Gotta hit the club, gotta make that jump. Gotta hit the club like you hit them angles. With your phone out, snapping like you Fabo. And you showing off, but it's alright. And you showing off, but it's alright. It's a short life.
Breakdown.
Century. Doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen. Do it. Screams from the haters. Got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just count the hours. Stop tripping. I'm tripping off the power. Broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing to lose. Everybody, we rolling. Everybody, we rolling. With some light-skinned girls and some Kelly Rollins. And this white man world, we the ones chosen. So good night, cool world. I see you in the morning. I see you in the morning. This is way too much. I need a moment. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking. I just count the hours. Tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Till then, that the world's ours. Kissing nail in the whole cast. Tell them easy said they could kiss my whole ass. More specifically, they could kiss my ass. I'm an ass. Mine and sauce is Napoleon. My furs is mine, Goldie. And my ice brought the goalies. And I embody every characteristic of the egotistic. He knows he's so f***ing gifted. I just needed time alone with my own thoughts. Got treasures in my mind, but couldn't open up my own vault. My talent, like creativity, purity, and honesty is honestly being crowded by these grown thoughts. Reality is catching up with me. Taking my inner child, I'm fighting for custody. With these responsibilities that they entrusted me. As I look down at my diamond and crush the piece. Thinking no one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours.
stop tripping, I'm tripping off the powder. Peel in that the world's ours.
Welcome back into Steel Hall for the intermission report. Kevin Syracuse here with Trevor Howard now. And Trevor, a pretty, as I was telling Josh, a very mediocre game, you know, pretty even. Neither team did anything good and neither team did anything bad. Just a bunch of back and forth hockey.
Yeah, sometimes 0-0 scores are fun to watch. But in this case, nothing really has been going on. And Fredonia had a good chance to take the 1-0 lead. But they went 0-1 on the power play as Potsdam took an early penalty just 5:06 into the game. Fred hit the goalpost. Unfortunately, that did not go in. And the time on attack, I've noticed, Potsdam has just been all over Fredonia. They've been working the puck really, really well deep in the Fred zone. And what I've noticed is Fredonia, whenever they get the puck in the offensive zone, they shoot it right away. They don't stop to work it around. Potsdam does the exact opposite, and that's why they're getting a lot of shots on goal.
Yeah, Fredonia really hasn't been able to get their offense set up. They have 7 shots on goal. Well, 9 if you count the 2 that clanked off the post.
Yep.
So 9 shots, and nothing really was going. I believe only 3 or 4 shots on that power play.
Unfortunately, none of them could go in, but yeah.
Yeah, and then the 2 went off the post came from that power play. So, yeah, very even game here.
Very, very clean game as well.
Yeah.
Only 1 penalty taken, so hopefully it stays that way. We don't want it to get chippy.
Yeah, and Anton Rosen looks good again. 14 saves, 14 shots, 14 saves. There have been a couple loose pucks in front of the net, a couple scrambles, but either Rosen's been able to cover up or one of the Fredonia defenders has been able to get it out of there.
He's doing a very good job in standing his ground. That's a big reason why Fredonia didn't let any of the goals in. That's why we're still in the game.
And once again, last night, as Mike Igo is here now. Mike Igo, a professor here after retiring from Channel 2 News. Oh, okay, so last night, 5-0.
Big win.
That was a game, yeah, big win. And that was a game where they looked really good from start to finish. Their offense was clicking. That was probably one of the best defensive games I've seen all year.
Absolutely.
And, you know, I think the evidence is proven with the fact that they killed off 9 minutes of penalties.
Including
in the first
minute
period.
Major.
Yeah.
And I think you can credit the goaltending as well. He was holding his ground yesterday, and he remains doing that tonight.
Yeah, so they each had 33 shots last night. So he had a 33-save shutout. So, you know, Rosen looks good again tonight, but the offense is going to have to pick up the slack a little bit and get going and try to have that same pace that they did last night.
Exactly.
You know, this is such a big event of the year, probably the biggest Fredonia sporting event of the year.
Absolutely.
And, you know, the crowd really hasn't had anything to cheer about, but at the same time, Fredonia's not doing anything bad. You know, credit to both teams. They're limiting each other. And we'll see what the second period brings, see who can get on the attack here.
Absolutely. Thoughts on the pink jerseys, Kevin?
I love them.
I think they're awesome.
Once again, you know, if you don't know, Fredonia, they wear the names of cancer survivors or ones
in their
who
family.
Have lost their lives due to cancer. And, you know, the families or friends make donations. And this event has raised $91,000.
Which is amazing.
Over 14 years. And then the first year, this got on SportsCenter as one of the top plays.
Yes, and yes, we said hockey is on SportsCenter, believe it or not.
Yeah.
They showed hockey on SportsCenter.
Yes, yes. So, yeah, as the Blue Devils website says here, the 2020 game represents the 14th season. Fredonia State Hockey has recognized cancer survivors. Purchase of game-worn jerseys began in 2008 and has formed the bulk of the program's $91,000 donation toward breast cancer research by the American Cancer Society.
And we only hope the number goes up. We hope you hit 100,000 sometime soon.
That would be great. So any last thoughts here, Trevor?
I say for Fredonia, they need to get more shots on goal because getting doubled in shots on goal is obviously not ideal, especially in front of all these fans at Pink the Rink night. If they get more shots, one of them is bound to go in.
All right, well, that will do it for the intermission report. Josh and I will be back in about 4 minutes to get you ready for the start of the second.
Welcome back to Hockey Night in Fredonia here at Steel Hall. Second period's about to kick off here. 0-0 score, Fredonia and Potsdam. Pink the Rink night, always a fun night for the fans. Shots last period, 14 for Potsdam and 9 for Fredonia. Even though the stat sheet says 7, we know better. As we said all period, kind of a mediocre type period, you know? Wasn't really many scoring chances or anything like that, but just kind of lackadaisical period for Fredonia.
Yeah, like we keep saying, neither team did anything good and they didn't do anything bad. So we'll see who comes out more. We're going to see who wants it more this period.
Right.
As we are underway now.
Fredonia has it in their own zone. Gamache up to Tracy. Tracy can't get a stick on it. And Potsdam dumps it back into the Fredonia zone. Manley in to chase it. Passed it there by Farrell. He comes up with the puck. Trying to work it out in front. Potsdam working together now. Down low to Farrell. Farrell can't hold on to it. Here comes Tracy the other way with Fredonia trying to break out of his own zone. They get it cleared and Haynes can't get a hold of it. lays a hit there on Leith to finish it off. Right in front of Ferroni's bench now. Cork and Barley putting the hits on. Here comes Farrell the other way for Potsdam. Farrell, cross-ice pass, and Potsdam is offside. Oh, Haynes and Farrell getting into it there after the whistle. Been seeing those two go at it all night long. And see if we get another chippy Fredonia game tonight. But draw will come just outside the Fredonia zone. Kirbis on the draw for Fredonia. Terranova wins it for Potsdam as he tries to get a shot on net. It's broken up by Kirbis. Fredonia recollects back behind their own net. McCabe over to Blitz. Blitz. Dimakopoulos can't jump up and catch it, and Potsdam will keep it in. Dimakopoulos has it now. Kirbis trying to break in with Dimakopoulos. Dimakopoulos gets to the center. Dunner trying to get a shot on net. Can't hold on to the puck there. Potsdam breaks it up, trying to get out of their own zone, but Fredonia holds it in. Now they have to recollect it at the point. Blitz puts a shot on Pegluka and swallows it up and dumps it off to his D-man. Here comes Potsdam the other way. Terranova working it through the center. Around Letmanski, rings it around the boards. Ryder comes into it there with Winnicates. Him and Winnicates come together. But McCabe comes up with the puck for Fredonia. Fans on the pass, has to pass behind his own net to safety to Blitz. Blitz up the opposite boards to Ryder now. Back to Blitz. He's trying to find Letmanski. He can't get it to him, and that'll be an icing against Fredonia.
So still nothing really cooking here in the first minute and 50 seconds.
Kind of a both teams trying to still feel each other out, it seems like. Usually they get that out of the way in the first period, but still plugging away at each other here in the second.
Maybe that means we're in for a good finish.
Yep. Clark recollects for Potsdam, dumps it into the Fredonia zone. McCabe has it now. Long lead pass up to Ryder. Ryder might be in all alone. Ryder trying to break free. Can't contain the puck as he goes into the corner with Cruikshank. Almost in on a breakaway there. Broken up by Fredonia again. Here comes Fredonia into the zone, and Pegluka makes a glove save. Clark works it up the boards to Bloom. Flipped out of play there by, I don't know who, but I don't know how it got flipped out of play. Everyone was so close together, I don't know how it didn't go off a body. Draw just in front of Fredonia's bench here, right outside the Potsdam zone. Judd on the draw. Potsdam wins it back into their own zone here. Third up ice, broken up by Fredonia. Potsdam recollects it back now, and here they come over the Fredonia line. Crashing and banging along the boards right in front of us here. His sticks are colliding and so are the bodies. Potsdam behind Fredonia's net, works it out to the point. Leith can't hold it in for Potsdam as he has to dump it back in now into the Fredonia zone. Johnson behind his own net. Trying to work it up. Shot there by Potsdam, and Rosen turns it into the corner. Johnson picking it out for Fredonia. Broken up by Potsdam. Potsdam possible two-on-one and broken up by Martin. Martin off the boards. Whitman clears it out. Here's Gorey in a foot race. Gorey in a foot race with Leith. Leith will win that and take it behind his own net, and Fredonia will go off for a change. Leith working through the neutral zone. Flips it into Farrell. Farrell tries to put it on net and puts it high and wide into the netting. And it'll be a draw to the right of Rosen with 16:41 to go here in the second.
So each team with just one shot here in the second period. 15-9 now.
Potsdam wins the draw back to the point. Shot fanned on by Clark, puts it down low. Manley going in after it. Potsdam comes up with it. Rosen holding tight to his post. Potsdam trying to work it around the other side now. Down in the corner. Gamache battling along with Cork and Barley. Right along next to Rosen. Rosen doesn't have a stick. But everyone piles in front. It goes in. It's just ref is waving it off. Goalie interference, possible call here. And Farrell thinks he's done it and scored for Potsdam. But
you know, Rosen covered up, and then it ended up trickling into the net. I think
Rosen was pushed.
Yeah, and I think it trickled in. Or I think they blew the whistle before it trickled in.
To paraphrase from an iconic Disney movie. Name this movie. Rosen was pushed instead of Humpty Dumpty was pushed from Toy Story. It sounded better in my head. I'm gonna stop talking now. Kirbis on the draw here to Rosen's right. No goal. Kirbis will take it against Terranova here. Terranova wins it back to the point. Shot, that one goes in as Clark squeaks it under the legs of Rosen. And that one's a for sure goal for Potsdam here.
Man, everything was quick about that one. Quick shot.
Quick face-off win,
quick shot, and it went right out of the net.
Yeah, hit that back bar and came out with speed. Rosen just couldn't get down quick enough, and it's 1-0 Potsdam.
So on the 17th shot for Potsdam, it goes in. So they score first tonight. Fredonia looking to tie it up now.
Potsdam wins the draw, comes back into the Fredonia zone, shot on Rosen, and he'll gobble that one up. Oh, and Kalu comes flying in with a crosscheck in here. Got bodies banging all over the place. And everybody's pairing off a little bit, but the refs are breaking it up. I think Kalu's going to go off for a penalty here. That was quite an aggressive hit there by Fredonia's number 9, Kalu. Might be offsetting Miners here. The Salau is going too. Salau goes to the box along with Kalu, so it's good to see Kalu didn't get tossed for that one, because I think that if that ref was in a bad enough mood, he could have just been like, get out of here. But, you know, now it goes to 4-on-4 hockey for the next 2 minutes, and see if this can open up things for Fredonia here.
And they're chirping at each other in the penalty box now.
Right. I like this kind of hockey from Fredonia. It's bodes well sometimes, but other times not so much. You got to make sure you make them mad enough, but don't take enough penalties on your own, because we know how that turns out for Fredonia.
Now they just have Kalu on the scoreboard for
right.
A penalty.
Well, actually, no.
Oh.
Salau, 2 minutes for slashing. So two penalties against Fredonia here.
So okay,
Kalau got two for cross-checking and roughing, so it'll be a 5-on-4 for 2 minutes. But Salau is also in the box. So Fredonia goes to the penalty kill for the first time tonight. Potsdam wins the draw back to the point. At the point is it with Leith. Swings it over. Terranova puts it down low. Potsdam battling behind the Fredonia net here as McCabe's got his guy pinned. Puck's stuck in down low, works up to the corner, now up to Leith at the point. Leith puts it down to Farrell, back to Leith at the point. Leith, back to Farrell. Farrell on the circle, puts it down low, shot on net. Rosen hugs the post, and the puck's blown dead, and everyone's jumbling on top of each other. And things are getting even more rowdy now, and ref's pointing. It looks like there might be another penalty here.
And that was Jasper Cork on Barley, and number 3, Bryce Farrell. Wrestling down low. They both went down.
Cork and Barley looks to be going to possibly his, or no, that's Tyler Ryder. Trying to work all this out here, see who's going to go where. And Ryder's going to go to the box now. And that'll be a 5-on-3 now for Potsdam. With a minute 30 to go on the first penalty.
Wow. So three are in the box now because
Ryder.
The Blue Devils had to send another one in the box.
For Kalu.
Yeah, for Kalu. So it's going to be 5-on-3 for a minute and a half here. So Fredonia really has their work cut out for them, and they have to be really careful now because, you know, they're down 1-0. Now they're starting to get some penalties. They got to keep their cool here. You know, they're not down 4-0. Nothing
yep.
to worry about. You're only down 1. So keep your composure and just play your game.
To the puck. Leith has it at the point now. Puts it over to Terranova. Back to Leith. Leith down low. Shot from the circle. Off the post. Brings around to Farrell. Farrell has it at the point. Down low to Terranova. Terranova back to Farrell. Farrell with a shot. Shot wide. The point held in by Potsdam, over to Leith, over to Farrell. Farrell working out of the circle, centers it, can't
nice get
away
defense.
By Fredonia. Potsdam keeps it in. Farrell works it down low to Terranova, broken up there by Haynes. Haynes working in against Terranova. Terranova behind the Fredonia net. Now into the opposite corner here. Worked along the boards back to the point for Leith. Broken up by Haynes, and it is cleared.
That was a great shift there from Haynes, Cork on Barley, and Martin.
Haynes gets off for a change, but here comes Potsdam the other way. Potsdam breaking in. Down low to the circle. Potsdam looks to be making a bit of a change themselves here. Down the circle now. Shot! Shot wide. Recollected by Potsdam behind the Fredonia net. Work back up to the point to Winnicates. Winnicates works it down low. Shot! Rosen gets down to stick the save. Cork on Barley can't break it up there.
20 seconds left in the first penalty.
Oh, and somebody attempted the Michigan goal there. Back at the point now for Potsdam. Puck goes into the corner. A couple bodies go flying with it. Winnicates has it at the point now for Potsdam. First penalty is expiring. Potsdam shooting from the circle. Rosen makes a save and swallows it up. Fredonia has killed off their first penalty with 28 seconds to go on the second one. So that was an interesting move there from Claire. He tries to do the Svechnikov coming around behind Rosen. Almost pulls it off as well.
Yeah, so now both penalties to Kalu have ended. So it'll be 5-on-4 for 28 seconds as Ryder is the only one in the box now.
I think Kalu's coming out now on the penalty kill possibly.
Yep, he'll be taking the draw.
So great work here by Fredonia on the penalty kill and almost some spectacular moves pulled off there by Potsdam's number 27, Robert Clare. That would have been an awesome highlight reel goal right there. Doesn't matter who you're supporting. You always want to see something like that happen.
Well, luckily for Fredonia's sake, it's still
right.
A one-goal game here.
Yep. Jeff Meredith is talking to the refs here. I don't know what's going on. Refs might be saying...
Ryder's talking from the box, too.
Can't tell what's going on here, but somebody's coming off the bench and going back to the box.
They're putting Kalu back in the box.
Right, because his second penalty is still going, technically.
Oh, so that one
I think
stays for another
I think
20 second, 28 seconds too then?
I believe so. I'm not sure here. This is a...
Yeah, but no, they still have four on the ice here.
Right. I'm not quite sure what's going on here, but we're only back to 5-on-4, and Potsdam wins the puck, or wins the draw. Has to recollect in their neutral zone. Here's Winnicates now for Potsdam. Winnicates dumps it in. Rosen comes out to collect it, slows it down. Gamache collects it now behind his own net. And what's the call here? Another unknown whistle blown. I think it might be icing. Icing against Potsdam. Yep, Fredonia will come down to the right of Begluka.
Well, 15 seconds left on these penalties.
Yeah,
we
so
think.
We think. We're not quite sure. I don't even know if the refs know, but we'll find out here in 15 seconds as Fredonia, or Potsdam wins the draw, excuse me. Potsdam behind their own net now. Claire works it up the boards. Cross ice pass to Winnicates. Can't connect. Winnicates picks it off the boards. Winnicates down low in the corner. Goes into the corner there with Fredonia. Cleared out in front. Nobody home. And Cork and Barley comes up to collect it. Cork and Barley in on a 2-on-1 possibly. Into Haynes. Can't get a stick on it. Cleared in front of the net. Now it's behind the Potsdam net.
So the penalty, both of them have ended, but Kalu's still in the box, but it is 5-on-5 right now.
Here comes Potsdam up the wing. Now Fredonia steals it away. Here comes Haynes the other way with Cork and Barley and Tracy. Haynes tries, can't connect with Cork on Barley. Cork on Barley in front of his own bench. Gets the puck down low. Almost gets it to Haynes as Venter breaks it up, and that puck will just trickle out of play into the Fredonia bench. I wonder how much longer they're going to make Kalu sit in there. I don't know what. Maybe it's like kind of like a fighting major where you got to sit in there the whole 5 minutes, but I didn't think they didn't call it as a fighting major, you know?
Yeah, they said what? Cross-checking and
roughing.
Roses and roughing. Okay, yeah.
I believe, but I don't know. It's a bit of a puzzling call there. Draw to the left of Pagluka, and Potsdam will win it.
Yeah, so technically he should have been out.
Manly was shot on. And
he should have been out of the box after the 4 minutes, I would think.
Right.
But it is 5-on-5.
Potsdam trying to clear out of their own zone here. Held in by Gamache. Demakopoulos gets it down low to Dunner, and Dunner can't get a stick on it as Potsdam clears it around the boards. Manly at the point now. Manly puts it in front. Nobody's home for Fredonia. Here comes Bloom the other way. Bloom and Thompson trying to work it through the neutral zone, and Fredonia breaks it up. Ahead for Dunner, but Dunner's out of gas, and that'll be icing against Fredonia.
Pizza time again.
Our headphone listeners, I ask you to please cover your ears. It's about to get very loud, and we can't do nothing about it.
So great job by Fredonia's PK.
Right.
Five on three for a minute 30. So they killed the 5-on-3 for a minute and a half. And going back to last night, I believe they killed off 5 penalties last night. And I know I keep saying this, but 9 minutes
right.
in the first period.
A consistent penalty kill. Farrell was behind the net now, trying to work it out in front for Potsdam. Still has it, pestered by Manley, and Manley finally breaks away. Manley up to Demakopoulos. He can't handle it. Back into the zone now for Potsdam. Here comes Giemann. Giemann and Farrell and Young trying to work it there for Potsdam. Cleared out a play by Fredonia, and it'll stay in Fredonia's zone to the right of Rosen. And Kalou finally comes out of the box here. He's finally released from jail. He must have had a get-out-of-jail-free card or roll the double or something.
So was that technically like a five-minute major then?
Maybe it was. I don't know. Maybe we'll never know. Maybe the refs will never know. Draw to the right of Rosen now. And Kalou is tossed from the face-off circle.
Well, we've definitely had some more excitement this period.
Right. Tyler Redder jumps in now for Fredonia. Wins it now. Manley along the boards. Not far enough for Kalou, and Potsdam keeps it in. They all scrum forward along the boards here. Potsdam behind the Fredonia net. Zweig with a shot on. Shot wide. Cleared up and out. No! It almost took somebody out in the penalty box there. One of the workers looked like it hit him right in the head, but just barely missed him. I think that's going to come to... The right, it's going to come back to Fredonia's zone to the right of Rosen. The FSU chant is started by the pep band. We come back to the right of Rosen with 11:30 to go. 1-0 Potsdam here at Fredonia, or here at, on Hockey Night in Fredonia. McCabe has the puck behind his own net now. Brings it over to Haynes. Haynes puts it back to Blitz. Blitz puts it up to Tracy, and that's going to go for icing. Fredonia can't catch a break here on these icing calls and head back to their own zone again, but fans are calling for Tracy to have touched it there.
Unfortunately, the pep band was doing the FSU chant, but the rest of the crowd didn't pick up on it.
Right, yeah, I was like, what are they saying? To the left of Rosen now. Draw one by Potsdam, shot way wide. Those rings around the boards, McCabe. Throws his man into the corner and takes the puck for himself over to Blitz. Now Blitz back to McCabe. McCabe drops his man again. Puck worked up to Haynes. Haynes trying to get in here now. And that'll be another icing for Fredonia. I don't know. Some of these are a little questionable. That one looked like it went right off Haynes' stick. But what I like there was McCabe tosses his own man, or tosses his guy, throws the puck to Blitz. Blitz puts it back to him. That guy gets up, tries to run McCabe, and McCabe just tosses a shoulder into him and says, no, thank you. Go home.
Did you see what he just did now?
What was that?
As they're skating to the bench, McCabe's still out there, but as this guy was skating to the bench, he gave him a little cross-check.
Really?
So they were still going at it.
Ronnie working out of their own zone now. Here comes Haynes to the neutral zone. Haynes makes a move. Puts it to Tracy. Tracy can't get his shot off. Puck goes dribbling into the corner. Tracy bodies his man into the corner, trying to work it out in front now. Can't do it. Behind the Potsdam net, Haynes dropped in the corner, and Potsdam will work it out the other way. Here comes Giemann. Giemann breaking in with Farrell. Farrell can't get a stick on it, and it'll go back to neutral zone. Leith trying to work it in for Fredonia. Dumps it in, or excuse me, for Potsdam. Dumps it in, and McCabe is swinging up the boards to Demakopoulos. Demakopoulos has it now. Dumps it in opposite corner to Potsdam zone. Winnicates picks it up for his team in his corner. Hooked up the ice now. MacArthur. Excuse me, that's Claire. Claire has it now. Down low to Salau. Salau puts it out in front for Winnicates, and it's broken up by Fredonia. Winnicates holds it in at the Fredonia line, and Demakopoulos finally forces it out. Here comes Terranova the other way. And Claire loses his footing, and Fredonia can dump it out of their own zone, and that'll be another icing. Fredonia's got to watch it on these icing calls here. It's a lot of draws in their own zone.
Under halfway through the second period, 9:45 left, 1-0.
What do we got for shots?
21-10. So Fredonia, really, they haven't been able to get anything generated here.
You know, I think part of that's coming from those penalties.
Yeah, so what did they have, 7 in the first, I believe? seven or eight. So they've only generated a couple shots here in the second period.
Right.
But you got to give Potsdam credit. Their defense has been real tough tonight.
Potsdam has it down low now. Here's Matura. Battling in there with two Fredonia Blue Devils. Back to the point now for Cruikshank. Puts it in down low. And Zika with a shot on, and Rosen turns it away into the corner. Fredonia desperately trying to clear here to get a change, and Cruikshank puts it up off a stick of Kirbis and into the netting, and Fredonia finally gets a change.
And a new puck, as
and
that
a
one
new puck.
Got caught in the mesh.
You think they'd figure out a system to keep those out of the mesh at this point. Get them down or something.
I see a couple up there.
Like a gutter system. Draw to the left of Rosen, and Potsdam wins it. Almost gets a quick shot off the draw. Here comes Fredonia the other way. Dumps it into the Potsdam zone. Judd chasing in after it for Fredonia. Behind the Potsdam net, worked around. Here comes Potsdam now trying to break it out of their own zone. Through the neutral zone here. Dumps it down in Fredonia's end. Rosen out to collect it, and Martin will collect it from his goalie and can't put it around the boards enough. Now he clears it. Dumped in there by MacArthur. Blitz will go back to recollect it. Blitz along the boards, almost takes off Gorey's head, and that'll be no icing. Finally, Fredonia gets it clear with no icing here as Winnicates clears it up the ice to MacArthur. Now Farrell trying to break in, and they were just offside. Farrell and MacArthur almost in on a two-on-one there. Draw come just outside the Fredonia zone. Right in front of us here. As Kalu will be on the draw against Young. Potsdam wins the draw. Richardson dumps it in. And oh, right on Rosen. He has to be awake there on that one. It goes wide. McKay battling with his man along the boards. Four or five man scrum along the boards there as they're all tangled up together, and McCabe's being held and he's trying to just get up.
Oh, that's a penalty.
That's got to be a penalty
he's
there.
He's still on him.
Potsdam has it down low now, and McCabe and his man still going at each other. Demon to McCabe.
I think the refs missed a holding there. I know they got to let him play it out, but he was right, literally was holding him down.
Right. Dumped into the Potsdam end here. Ryder gives chase against Richardson.
Like they're wrestling.
Right. No wrestling allowed in hockey. McCabe holds it at the point, gets a shot on. Oh, deflected wide by Ryder. Just wide. Ryder has it now, trying to work it out in front. Can't do it. Battling in the corner with Richardson. Richardson just has it pinned along the board there, and now Cork and Barley digs it free. Cork and Barley out in front. Martin with a shot, scores! Tommy Martin! Johnny on the spot, right out in front. Hammers it home, past Pagluka. And the pink towels are flying here tonight in Fredonia.
And just like that, we are tied at one. Real nice pass from Jasper Cork on Barley, and Tommy Martin's there to put it in the back of the net, and we have ourselves a tie game.
Squeaks it right underneath Pagluka, who thought he had himself in position, but it just barely fit in there. We have a 1-1 game.
And that brings some life back to this crowd as they were kind of just sitting there waiting for something to happen.
Right.
Well, finally it happened, and
Martin's,
tie game.
Martin's fourth goal of the year. Fredonia works back into the Potsdam end now. Here's Haynes on the puck. Haynes puts it back on Potsdam net. Clark rings it around the boards for Potsdam. Potsdam trying to break it out here. Fredonia breaks it up the neutral zone. Kamash dumps it in. Pagluka out to collect. Down low to the right of Pagluka. Potsdam trying to get it out of their own zone here. Haynes pestering them. Clark takes behind the net, his own net. Works up to Salau. Salau can't make a connection there with Zweig. And Zweig will chase in after against Manley. There's Horn. Puts it around the board to Salau. Salau shot on Rosen. Makes the save. Swallows that one up. I think that went up into his sleeve almost. Awkward angle shot, and Rosen just swallows it up. 6:38 to go here in the second period. If you're just joining us, for them, you just scored 1-1. Goal from Tommy Martin.
That was huge because, like I said, it was kind of, there wasn't much going on. It was pretty much all Potsdam. You know, they're getting outshot 23-10.
Right, Fredonia gets a little momentum back here. Here comes Kirbis in a foot race now. Kirbis trying to break into the Potsdam zone. Him and Winnicate's going at it into the boards. Winnicate clears it on the net, clears it on the boards. It's shot in front. Pegluka has to be awake on that one. Shot from the point there. Gets down onto it. Fredonia behind the net now. Tries to work it out in front. Pegluka kicks it away. Winnicate dumps it along the boards. Kept in there by Fredonia. Kept in. I think that's McCabe. McCabe trying to dangle through, and he gets tripped up. No call.
No, oh, there's a penalty coming.
Oh, there is a penalty. You can see the arm, ref's arm go up, and Fredonia pulls the goalie
bench
now.
Yep.
And here comes Kirbis breaking in. Kirbis trying to hang on to it. Gets it to Dunner. Dunner back to Kirbis, and oh, no. I don't think so, but apparently Potsdam had
I think that hit a stick.
Okay. Potsdam had enough possession there, and the whistle will go for Fredonia's second power play of the night. McCabe had a couple dirty dangles there, and he gets tripped up and can't make it all the way through.
So Fredonia will come out with their power line here. It'll be Victor Tracy, Charlie Manley, Jacob Haynes, Jasper Corgan Barley, and Ethan Kirbis.
It's a deadly line right there. Haynes on the draw. Potsdam wins it. Clears it. Oh, kept in there by Tracy. Tracy at the point. Works it down low. Back to Tracy. Tracy to Manley. Manley with a shot. Saved away by Pegluka.
Manley broke a stick.
Well, that's why
I was going to
say that was a pretty soft shot for Manley, and Potsdam clears their way here. Here comes Potsdam on a rush. Potsdam killing time here. Swings it over to Cruikshank. Cruikshank tries to settle it down, puts it out in front to Salau. Salau goes behind the net, tries to wrap around, and Rosen makes the save and is picked up behind the net by Fredonia. Salau still pestering them there, goes off the ref, and Salau has it in the corner battling with three Devils as his team's just kind of sitting back a little bit, trying to kill some time here. Fredonia breaking it out now. Long lead pass. Off Tracy's stick, so no icing. Winnicates goes back to collect it behind his own net. Tracy, down low to Dunner. Dunner behind the Potsdam net. Out to Haynes. Haynes to Manley. Manley over to Tracy. Tracy back to Manley. Manley back to Manley at the point. Manley shot! Shot wide. Haynes collects it now up to Tracy. Tracy can't keep it in and dribble all the way down to the other end of the ice. 49 seconds to go on the power play here. Rosen comes out to collect, way out of his net to collect it. And Manley has it now. Manley stolen away there by Machura, and Manley lays a hit on him and takes the puck right back.
Manley's got to be more careful. That's the second or third time he's had a puck stolen away from him.
Yeah, he's got to watch his handling there. Here comes Dunner the other way now. Dunner in the neutral zone. Doesn't like what he sees, so he circles back. Up to Ryder. Ryder breaks into the Potsdam zone, dumps it far corner. Fredonia picks it up, rings it around the boards. Behind the Potsdam net for Dunner. Dunner trying to find Martin at the point. Works down low, back up to Dunner at the point. Down to the circle, shot, rebound, on front, score! No goal, no goal! Off the line, cleared off the line by Potsdam.
Right in the crease.
I think Ryder thought, or...
Right as the penalty expired.
Whitman thought he had one there, but the penalty expires and Potsdam gets lucky there as they cleared off their own goal line. Here comes Potsdam the other way. Shot on net by Giemann, shot wide. Fredonia up to, trying to get it up to Ryder, intercepted here by Potsdam, working around behind the Fredonia net, trying to wrap around, put it up to the point, shot on! Blocked there by a down Fredonia player, I think it was Whitman. Up into the boards and now Potsdam has to reset. Will be another icing against Fredonia here, I think. Yep. Fredonia just trying to clear and slow down here with 3:11 left in the second period. Almost a 2-1 game for Fredonia as Whitman comes off the ice with an injury, it looks like.
Shots now 25-13.
I think Whitman there, he fell down in front of the net and took a shot right to the back, I think it was, right where there's no padding. And you know those ones hurt when you're not expecting it especially, but we'll hope he comes back. And Fredonia won the faceoff in their own zone here. Held in by Winnicates. Puts it down low. Shot on net there, gloved away by Rosen. Had to be awake there on Bloom's shot and holds onto it for another draw in the Fredonia zone to the left of himself. Fredonia finally get a change here.
3:03 remaining in the second. Once again, this is Hockey Night in Fredonia and Pink the Rink. Josh Schmidt and Kevin Syracuse here on Fredonia Radio.
Potsdam wins the draw. Shot from the point. Rosen gloves it again. Draw to the left, DeRozan, 2:59. Ryder will come out to take the draw here against MacArthur. Ref still holding on to the puck there. And Fredonia kind of wins the draw, gets it out of their own zone. Here comes Haynes the other way. Haynes breaking in and shoots off the post. Back at the point here. Work down low to Haynes. Haynes trying to deflect it on, and Potsdam will clear it away up their own, up to the wing here. Here comes Winnicates, dumps it in. Collected by Blitz. Blitz up to Haynes. Fredonia's first line out there now, and Haynes, Cork and Barley, and Tracy trying to keep it in the zone, and here comes Potsdam the other way at a 4-on-3. Shot on net, shot wide by Potsdam. Cruikshank keeps it in for Potsdam. He's pestered along the boards there by a couple Blue Devils. Worked out of here. Here comes Dimakopoulos now up the left wing. Dimakopoulos trying to get by his man. Brings it around the boards, and Manley will step up and put it back down to Dunner behind the net. Dunner holds onto the puck still. Dunner works it out in front. Shot at the point from Dimakopoulos, shot wide. Dunner to Kirbis. Kirbis with a shot. Flex off a stick into the corner. Back to the point now. For Gamash. Gamash gets it in front of the net. Nobody home for Fredonia. Dimakopoulos had his stick held onto. I think he broke his stick as well. I'll say I'm trying to break out here, but Fredonia intercepts in the neutral zone. Manley flips up the boards to Letmanski. Letmanski in on a 3-on-2 with his teammates. Drops it off. Shot! Kicked away by Pagluka. Here comes Salau the other way. Salau in a 3-on-1. Salau passes across. Shoot! Shot wide. Shot wide by Claire there. Now Fredonia works out of their own zone. Ryder tries to dump it in. Blocked away by Leith. Leith has it now for Potsdam.
Dumps under a minute to go here.
Caught by Gamash. Gamash flips it up the ice. No icing as the flex off Potsdam's stick. 50 seconds to go in the first period, or second period. Richardson holds it down low for Potsdam, trying to get out of his own zone. Here comes Salau now up the right wing. Left wing, excuse me. Salau puts it on, shot wide. Fredonia can't complete the pass, and shot thrust to the right of Rosen. Haynes gets taken out along the boards by Farrell, but Fredonia holds on to the puck in their own zone. Here's Blitz now in the opposite corner. Blitz trying to clear it up the boards. Can't do it. Potsdam holds it in. 19 seconds to go. Farrell tries to put out in front. Can't. Broken up by Fredonia. Here comes Tracy. One last push. 10 seconds to go for Fredonia. Tracy trying to get in. Trying to get it to Haynes. Can't do it. And Fredonia holds it in. Blitz with a shot. Turned away by Pagluka through traffic. Winnicates just trying to kill time, as that will kill the second period. A couple good chances there at the end of the period for Fredonia, but it will stay 1-1 at the end of the second. Thoughts, Kevin?
Well, that was a lot better period from each side, as shots are now 27-14. So Fredonia is still getting outshot a lot, but a lot better performance in that second period, as the scoreboard shows it, as it is now 1-1 heading into the third.
We'll be back in a minute with your intermission report. Until then, enjoy some music. You've been listening to WDVL 89. .5 The Inferno and WCVF 88.9 The Voice. Just got to get a little music going for you here. We'll be back with the second intermission report in just a minute.
He said one day. Told me.
like a feeling, yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, no. I get a good feeling, yeah. Oh, sometimes I get a good feeling, yeah. Get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no, no. I get a good feeling, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Here for the intermission report, Kevin Syracuse here with Trevor Hauer. And Trevor, a much better period for both sides, especially for Fredonia.
I'll say, yeah. You know, it was getting a little chippy in the beginning, but among both teams, as both teams got two slashing penalties and a rough. And we also saw a Potsdam goal get waved off 3:39 into the period. You can tell the Potsdam bench wasn't happy about that. But then literally 3 seconds later off the faceoff, they put one home to make it 1-0.
Well, ball don't lie. I guess pucks don't lie either.
They don't. Absolutely not. Not in this game.
So, yeah, like I was telling Josh, the shots are still a large, a pretty big deficit here for Fredonia, 27-15. But the main thing is one of those 15 shots went in.
Take them any way you can get them.
Rosen's been playing great again, so only one of their shots went in. So when it's all said and done, we have ourselves a tie game here.
And that's the way that Fred wants it because, like you said, 27 shots to 15 is like the ice is a little bit tilted in this game, but the score for sure is locked up at one. And what did you think about that Fredonia goal, 12:31 into the period to tie it up? I thought it was really, really clutch from my angle. You can take him any way you can get him, right?
Yeah, no, that was a beautiful pass. Cork and Barley had it down behind his net and just was patient enough, found Martin, who was cutting into the net, and Martin slapped it in. And just like that, it was a tie game. So Martin coming through again. He had a goal last night. Now he has a big goal tonight because, you know, that goal is huge. That goal was huge because, yes, it's only their first goal. Yes, it's only their 15th shot. I believe that was their 12th or 13th shot.
Yep.
But, you know, in a game like this, you want to see the energy. You want to see the energy at its highest. You want to see the momentum on your side. And there really wasn't any energy on Fredonia's side before that. So that was a huge goal because, again, in a game like this, it almost felt like they were down 3-0 instead of 1-0 just because there's so much on the line.
That was definitely the way it should have been from what it looked like. But then after halfway through the period, you saw Fred start to pick it up a little bit, start working around, playing the point, passing it down low, getting shots on goal. obviously one of the shots went in, which is great for them. And Potsdam was trying to respond, didn't happen. You can see as well, both teams took three penalties for six total minutes. Obviously, you want to keep the discipline at a high. And, you know, especially for Fredonia and Potsdam, two teams that are hungry for a big W tonight, staying out of the box is definitely a key factor in winning this game.
And once again, Tommy Martin had the goal. Jasper Cork and Barley with the assist. Tyler Ryder was also credited with the assist.
Yes.
And for Potsdam, that was Ethan Clark. He had the goal for them, and Thomas Terranova with the assist. I believe that was right off the faceoff, too. So about 6.5 to go. I think that will do it here for the intermission report. Any last thoughts before we head to the third?
We can only hope for the best for Fredonia. It's a 1-1 game. It's still anybody's hockey game. 20 more minutes to go. If you have to force overtime to win, that's just the way it's got to be, but we're hoping for a big W here coming from the Blue Devils.
Yeah, we should be in for a good one here as the third period is exactly 6 minutes away from starting. So once again, this is Trevor Howard joining me on the intermission report on Fredonia Radio, WCVF 88.9 and WDVL 89.5. Josh and I will be back in about 4 minutes to get you ready for the start of the third.
We skip line. I remember reminiscing in the kitchen lot. I wonder when them Braves gon' win it. I wonder when them Falcons gon' get here. Pyrex vision made more than I ever made with DTP this year.
Tired of living day to day like everything's alright. Every night just one thing on my mind. I'm just waiting on that moment. Waiting on my moment. You say how you got that off. As long as I stay hustling, I'm gon' shine. Just waiting on that moment. Waiting on my moment.
Just waiting on my moment. Bad, so I'm showing it. Time came and I owned it, just like Brian Jazz and start bowling. When I touched the rock and I cracked the block, when I pulled up and that mustard drop with that roof off and my shoes off and y'all roof off. Real in my hood, who everybody gon' roof off? They see me come from that bottom, where everybody get bodied. They told me get him, I got him. Now I'm here, nigga, like, yeah, this Rolls Royce and Bugattis. And M4's this year. If I don't grind, I don't shine. If I don't shine, then I don't eat. If I don't eat, then I'ma starve. And if I'ma starve, I pour on all y'all. All y'all rich.
Cause
if I don't make no money, I'm gonna take your money. Oh,
tired of living day to day like everything's alright. Every night just one thing on my mind. I'm just waiting on that moment. Waiting on my moment. You say, oh, you got that out shit. Hell no, next time that's mine. As long as I stay hustling, I'm gonna shine. I'm just waiting on that moment. I stay hustling, I'm gon' shine. Just waiting on that moment.
DJ Pro.
Thank you. We could bathe in all the lights. Would you rise up? Come and meet me in the sky. Would you trust me when you're jumping from the heights? Would you fall in the name of love? When there's madness, when there's poison in your head, when the sadness leaves you broken in your bed, I will hold you in the depths of your despair. But it's all testify, screaming the holy light. You bring me back to life, and it's all in the name of love. I wanna testify, screaming the holy light. You bring me back to life, and it's all in the name of love. In the name of love.
Welcome back to Hockey Night in Fredonia here at Steel Hall Ice Arena. Potsdam Fredonia 1-1, third period about to get going. Pink the Rink Night. You're listening on WDVL 89.5 and 89.5 The Inferno and WCVF 88.9 The Voice. Puck's about to be dropped here. Cora Carabarly squaring off against. Nice roster sheet go here. Oh, here we go. Potsdam wins the draw. Back into the Fredonia zone. Here's Gamache. Gamache works it up to Haynes. Haynes flips it in. Tracy in to chase it with Richardson. Richardson flips it around. Fredonia gets back here. Trying to work it out is Richardson, and he can't do so. It's a little help from his teammates there in Guimond. And here comes Potsdam the other way in a 2-on-2. Broken in there by Young. They battle in the corner. Young back to the point. Ventner with a shot. Swallowed up by Rosen and Gamache and Farrell getting into it in front of the net. And Gamache has some buddies coming in to help him out. Draw to the right of Rosen. We kick off the second period here. See who's going to be out there to take the draws now is Terranova. He'll take it for Potsdam. Terranova wins the draw for Potsdam now. Trying to put it back to the point here. And he does. It's a shot block there. Fredonia trying to break out of their own zone. Intercepted by Winnicates. Winnicates dumps it back down, rings it around the Fredonia boards. And Ventner will be in there to chase for Potsdam, but a little help from Salau, and Kiris will be in the corner to pester him out in front. Can't get a shot there from Terranova. But Potsdam holds firm and keeps the puck in the zone. Letmanski recollects it for his team now. Works it up by his bench, almost puts the move on him there, and Gamache comes in to help out. Letmanski with the puck back now, works it up to Kiris. Kiris breaking into the Potsdam zone. Kiris works around his man out in front. Dunner can't connect. Blitz dumps it far corner in the Potsdam zone. They collect it here by Venter. Venter dumps it in right on Rosen, gloves it down, and he'll hold on to that one.
Just about 2 minutes into this third period. Expect to see the same energy levels that we saw last period as play really picked up as the period went along.
Draw to the right of Rosen here. one by Fredonia. McCabe rings it around the boards to Ryder. Ryder can't get there in time, but lays a hit on his man. Kalu has it now. Clears it out of the zone. Dumps it in high. Back into the Fredonia zone on his Potsdam. McCabe helps the clear out. Ryder has it now in the neutral zone. Kalu tries to put the spin move on, and Pagluko will just cover that one up. So first draw in Potsdam's end tonight. Or tonight, this period, as it'll be to the right of Pagluko, and we'll have the line are we having out there right now. Looks like the Cork and Barley line will be back out, along with Johnson and his D partner. Potsdam wins the zone, wins the draw, tries to clear it out of their zone, can't do it. Zweig has it now. Works it up into the Fredonia zone. Shot on, cleared away by Rosen. Down low in the corner, and they battle for it. Fredonia comes up with it, trying to clear it out of their own zone, and Machura pesters Fredonia there, but Fredonia clears it out. Here comes Tracy the other way. Tracy breaking in. Down low on the circle. Down in the corner to Haynes. Haynes behind the net to Cork and Barley. Cork and Barley trying to work it out in front. Pestered there by the Potsdam defender. Tomas has it now. Down to Cork and Barley. Cork and Barley out front. Up front with a shot from Manley, and he turned away by Pagluko. Manley still has it now. Gets it down low to Haynes. Haynes up top for Kirbis. Kirbis trying to hold it in at the point. Can't do it, and Potsdam will clear it out of their own zone. Fredonia comes right back in, though. Here comes Tracy. Drags it through his defender. Out in front of Kirbis. Kirbis shoots. Saved by Pagluko. He'll cover that one up, and it's a great chance there for Kirbis. Beautiful pass from Tracy through his defender's legs.
Fredonia getting some nice chances here.
Yeah, Fredonia's definitely poured it on here in the beginning of the third period, trying not to let this one slip through their fingers. As Haynes let Mansky, an unknown left winger, are out there right now. Potsdam wins the draw. Here's Richardson behind his own net. Swings it around to Guimond. He'll dump it into the Fredonia zone, and Blitz will win the race for icing. And it'll come right back down to Potsdam's end.
30-17 are the shots now.
Face-offs, we got 31 for Fredonia, 21 for Potsdam. Three and three on the penalties tonight as well. Kirbis on the draw now. Vince Young. Kirbis can't keeps wins the draw or loses the draw, but keeps the puck in. As behind Potsdam's net now, trying to work it out in front. Potsdam does now. Here comes Guimond. Guimond up to Farrell. Farrell shot blocked. Worked back down low to him. Guimond trying to get the puck back for Potsdam now, and Farrell does it. Kept in the point by Richardson. Richardson trying to swat it in, and all Young can do for Potsdam is bat it down into the corner. Puck dribbles out in front. Shot scores! Farrell picks up the pass out in front. I believe that was from Guimond, who picked up a lost Fredonia pass. The pass looked like it came off the side of the net, and Guimond puts it down low, and Farrell was wide open.
Wide open to the left of Rosen. Fredonia's defense was sucked to the
right
of Rosen, and that left Farrell wide open. And now the Bill Shout song starts.
Yeah, right? I can't understand that one, but
I mean, usually that's after the Bills score, so I understand trying to get the crowd hyped here. So
it was assisted by Young, and it is now 2-1 with less than about 15 minutes to go here in the third period. Fredonia's got a from the Jets on here as Potsdam gets a shot on net, and Rosen turns it away. Here comes Demikopoulos now trying to break it out. Demikopoulos up to Martin. Martin puts it in on net, and Ryder can't get to the goalie, and he's thrown into the net by Winnicates after the whistle. Ooh, and Ryder gets up and gives Winnicates a piece of his mind, but that'll be it, and they'll separate themselves and go to their respective benches.
You know, Josh, a key play that could affect the outcome of this game was that shot that trickled in. It looked like it was I don't want to say whether it was in or
Fredonia,
not, but
the Fredonia,
for Fredonia, yeah, I believe it was Haynes.
Yep.
And the ref said no goal. I don't remember exactly the timing of that, but
last period, I think about halfway through.
But there was
Fredonia keeps the puck down in the Potsdam corner now. As Tracy's pestered in the corner, swings it around the boards to Haynes. Haynes pestered as well, swings it back around to Tracy. Tracy gets a shot on net. Pegluka turns it away. Rebounds. Oh, I thought that went in. Haynes almost had it batted out of the air there. And Cork on Barley tries to clear it out in front, but to no one. And Manley will recollect in the neutral zone. Up to Haynes. Haynes coming into the right, but to the left of Pegluka. Haynes puts it off the glass, comes out in front, but Potsdam will pick it up and clear it out. Hit the linesman again. That linesman
the refs are
is
taking
a beating tonight. Took it right off the back of the head. I don't know if the puck will come back to the Potsdam zone, but I think they're going to say that it went out of play. And that linesman's going to one of the Fredonia bench here. Maybe get a look at by the trainer. Make a double check. Make sure not everything's intact on his head.
14:52 here on Pink the Rink night.
Linesman still getting his head looked at. Hopefully he's okay. I think the puck's going to come just outside of the Potsdam zone, right in front of their bench. But we shall see.
Once again, if you are just tuning in, this is a huge game for Fredonia. They are dead last in the SUNYAC right now. So the top six teams make the playoffs. Cortland and Morrisville are tied for sixth with 10 points each. Fredonia has six. So
it's doable.
It's doable.
I mean, this is also a big game for Potsdam. You've got to think about that, too.
Yeah,
Potsdam's got 11
fifth.
Points. So Potsdam needs to win this to stay in a playoff spot. And, I mean, I'm not entirely sure what the SUNYAC schedule looks like tonight. But, you know, if Morrisville and Cortland are playing each other, you know, that's going to be an intense game. And at this point, Fredonia's rooting for whoever's playing against Cortland and Morrisville. Because Fredonia needs to win out basically to make it to the playoffs.
And it's not going to be easy because after this game they have Brockport, Geneseo, Cortland, and Oswego.
Right. So that game against Cortland is going to, if it's still alive, and that's at Cortland too. But that is going to be a big game against Cortland, and Geneseo. That's, you know, they're 8-1-2 in the conference. That's a tough opponent right
18
there.
18 points.
18 points. 8-1-2. 15-3-2 on the year. Linesman appears to be okay. Plays looks like it's about to resume here, but
that makes tonight's game that much more important because,
yeah, I mean,
other than Cortland, Potsdam is probably the weakest team that they're going to face, and they're not even weak. It's just that
right. It's just statistically compared to other teams that they're going to be playing, and even you could even win four out of the last five
and still not make it.
Well, you could still make it in, I think, if you win on four out of the last five, depending on who loses. So you're hoping to win four and then maybe lose your one to Geneseo, because if you want to pick one to lose, it's probably that one.
Yeah, because it's not that.
Wins a draw now and trying to break in there on a quick play. And sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off there, Kev, but Fernando looked to be in on goal there for a second.
I was going to say, not only do they have to win, they have to hope that the other teams lose.
Right, exactly. Here comes Tracy now in all alone. Tracy on peg. Lucas scores! Victor Tracy gets him on the stick side. 2-2 Fredonia and Potsdam.
Tracy comes in all alone and snipes one home. And once again, we have ourselves a tie game.
Beautiful lead pass from the other offensive circle from Fredonia's defensive zone. Tracy was just waiting at that blue line. And, you know, he'd been waiting for that one all night. Fredonia looks, you always see it in the third period. Fredonia stretches their passes a lot, but there was a big goal there for Victor Tracy and for Fredonia, as it's now 2-2 with 14:32 to go in the third period.
Well, that was a huge goal for Tracy.
Potsdam working through the neutral zone now. It won't be icing as they dump it in the Fredonia zone. Rosen flips it over to Manley. Manley up the boards to Ryder. Ryder over to Blitz, or Gamache. Gamache puts it all the way down on Pegluka. Fredonia with a quick shot on now. Dribbles high and wide. Goes all the way down the ice, and Rosen will come out to play it. way out of his net, slings it over to Manley. Manley puts it back over to Gamache. Gamache up the boards and intercepted by Clark. Clark over to his D partner in Cruikshank. Cruikshank working it through, dumps it in. Rosen thinks about it, not coming out to get it this time. Johnson has it now for Fredonia, puts it to Gamache. Gamache to Dunner. Dunner intercepted by Potsdam, and they score! Miscue pass there by Dunner to Machura. Machura makes no mistake when he passes it over to Panzica as he buries it on the left side of Rosen. Rosen can't do much about it there. Another miscue of a pass there from Fredonia.
Yeah, and again, a bare player is left wide alone to the left of Rosen.
Yeah, I mean, that's how they've scored two of their goals now tonight, and Fredonia's got to watch those where he passes. Fredonia wins the draw now.
Who had the turnover there?
I think it was Dunner. Potsdam dumps it into the Fredonia zone, and that will be icing, I believe, or offside.
So 3-2 is the score. Potsdam with the lead, 13:25 left in the game.
Three quick goals here in the beginning of the third period. I don't know why the draw is coming back to the Fredonia zone. It looked to be offside, but...
Oh, there's a penalty.
Oh.
Going to be to Anders Johnson.
It's a draw to the right of Rosen. One by Fredonia. Fredonia gets the clear.
2 minutes for
first
interference.
Clear of the penalty kill. Potsdam behind their own net. Here comes Leith working it out now. Drops it off to Terranova. Terranova breaking in with speed. Terranova brings it around the boards. Tommy Martin trying to clear it here for Fredonia. Gets it out of the zone, but not all the way down the ice. As Young comes back to collect it and brings it behind his own net. Over to Leith. Leith working through the middle now. Trying to find some space. Dumps it in into the left side of the Fredonia zone. And Martin will pick it up again, trying to clear it once again for Fredonia, and Potsdam will hold it in this time, barely, and now dribbles out of the zone. Leith up the boards to Giemund, and Giemund trying to break in but can't get past his man, and Fredonia clears again. Minute left in this penalty kill for Fredonia, minute left in the power play for Potsdam. Here comes Horn. Horn up to Winnicates. Winnicates breaking in by the Fredonia bench. Rings it around the boards. Back to Horn. Horn puts it behind Fredonia's net. Manley will clear it all the way down the ice, and Pagluka will come out to collect. Potsdam looking for one last push here. Here comes Horn. Picking up the left wing. Horn centers it. It's tangled up in Fredonia's feet and cleared off into the corner. Back off, point to point here. Shot from Winnicates. Blocked away by Fredonia. Trying to clear it. Can't do it. Gets it into the corner.
12 seconds left on the penalty.
Horn has it now along the half wall. Horn checked by his man and kept in by Potsdam out in front. And Rosen turns it away, and Fredonia clears it. Questionable call there. Played by a high stick by Venter, and the penalty will expire.
And so Fredonia kills another penalty. Potsdam is 0 for 4 tonight. Plattsburgh was 0 for 4 last night. This penalty kill is coming up huge for Fredonia.
Here comes Tracy the other way now with Corkinbarley and Haynes. Corkinbarley has the puck along the half wall. Corkinbarley trying to find Gamache at the point, can't do it. Here comes Cruikshank trying to break it off for Potsdam. Cruikshank puts it up the boards. Gamache breaks it up. Gamache on the Potsdam line gets it stolen away by Salau. Haynes pestered Salau there, and he loses the puck back to Fredonia. Gamache and Salau come together right in front of us here as Tracy trying to swing it up the boards to Martin, but he goes off for a line change, and that'll go all the way down for an icing against Potsdam.
10:39 remaining.
These offensive zone draws for Fredonia like this one are going to be key, very key, coming in the last 10 minutes here for if they want to tie it, which you know they do. I mean, it's a very big game for both teams that we've been saying all night, and sure to get more and more intense as we go along here. Ryder wins the draw for Fredonia into the corner. Ryder and Salau come together in the corner, and here comes Clarko with the puck. Intercepted by Manley. Manley trying to keep it in. He does. Demakopoulos has the puck now along the half wall. Demakopoulos puts it in front, broken up by Potsdam. Recollected by Johnson in his own zone. Johnson can't connect with Kirbis, and that'll be icing this time. Coming back down to the Fredonia end. Shots are now 33-22 in favor of Potsdam. So Fredonia's really got to get the shot machine working here as the draw comes down to the right of Rosen. Young wins the draw for Potsdam, trying to get a quick shot on net. Blocked away, and jump ball between Ryder and Leith as they're at the line trying to catch the puck out of the air, but I think that one came out for an offside.
So we'll do it again.
Kind of an interesting play there between Ryder and Leith. So you can jump higher on ice. Cork on Barley out to the draw now against Young. Cork on Barley out there with Whitman and Letmanski. He wins the draw. Here comes Fredonia. Picking up the left wing. Dumped in there. Richardson has it now. Gets it up to Guimon. Blocked by Letmanski. Letmanski trying to keep it in for Fredonia. Young breaks him up here. And dumped back into the zone by Blitz. Leith has it behind his own net, over to Richardson. Richardson up to Farrell, breaking up by Letmanski, out in front for Whitman. Whitman shoots, scores! Beautiful play there by Matt Letmanski, as that's Bryce Whitman's first collegiate goal. Almost had one earlier in the night, but now he has one for sure. 3-3 here in Fredonia. 9:40 to go.
Great defense from Matt Letmanski. He's been playing great these last couple nights. Forces another turnover and finds Whitman, and he snipes one home. And once again, tie game.
Beautiful feed by Letmanski. I mean, we've seen three of those goals tonight now, with the two of them coming from Potsdam, breaking up a failed pass from Fredonia trying to get out of their zone. And now, oh, and there will be a penalty on Potsdam as well. So power play for Fredonia here. We saw this the other night against a couple weeks ago against Buff State. But must have been a delayed call, and Whitman will bury it and send Fredonia to the power play. But great moment for him getting a goal here tonight on Pink the Rink night. First collegiate goal for him. And saw that. You saw that last night with Gamache, and it's got to be an awesome feeling for him. You could just see it in his celebration. He jumped into the boards. He's running around with his teammates. I mean, that's awesome. Awesome to see for him.
And a perfect time to do it, too. You know, down 3-2 with under 10 to go. Fredonia, they weren't in desperation mode. There's still a lot of time, but.
And now you're going to the power play as well.
Yeah.
24. Wow, that's the second time this year I've done that. I guess that was Ryder's goal. I thought that. I could have sworn that was Whitman.
I think it was. Let's see our score sheet here.
There's no way that was Ryder.
I don't even think Ryder's on the same line.
No.
Let's see here.
Check our live stats here, see if they're updating.
Yeah, they didn't give it to Ryder. Where are we here? I don't think they put it on yet.
I'm pretty sure
that was Whitman.
It's got to be. There was no way it's not. I saw 14 clearly.
Yeah, no.
Trust me, I'm not crazy. Potsdam wins the draw, neutral ice.
Yep, okay, there it is. It was Whitman. You're good, Josh.
Okay. That would have been the second time this year. Fredonia breaking out of their own zone now behind the net. Cork on Barley leading the charge. Broken up by Potsdam. Beautiful diving play there from Cruikshank. As Fredonia has to recollect now.
Just for clarification, Fredonia is on the power play now.
Right. Fredonia trying to reset in their own zone here. Here's Kirbis coming through the neutral zone. Kirbis breaks in along the half wall. Trying to put it back to the point to Manley. Manley can't get to it, and it's cleared out by Salau as Potsdam will go off for a change. Cork on Barley comes back in his own zone to collect it. Pestered there heavily by the Potsdam player, and Manley comes in to assist as Manley swings it up the wing. Here comes Fredonia breaking in. Drop back to Manley. Cork on Barley can't keep it in, and here comes Potsdam in on a breakaway.
And they're going to have a penalty.
Breaking in, shoots, saved by Rosen. Glove save, and that'll be a penalty on Manley, I'm assuming, for hooking, as we saw Terranova tripped up there, held back at least. So Fredonia's power play has disappeared with 57 seconds to go on it. And Manly will head to the box. Corakon Barley will head to the box.
Yeah, he was trying to prevent the breakaway, and he didn't do that as he was able to stay on his feet.
Yep, but Rosen comes up big with a big glove save. We have some 4-on-4 hockey for the next 57 seconds.
So the PK is going to have to come up big one more time here.
Martin has it behind his own net. Remember, he can't clear it. It's 4-on-4. Here comes Fredonia breaking out of their own zone. Gamash dumping it in. Ryder in to give chase, along with Kalau. Kalau pressures. Crookshank gets it to Ryder. Ryder angles, puts it back to Gamash. Gamash shoots. Saved by Pegluka and bounces around in front.
Man, I thought that went in.
It almost looked like it did. Looked like it went off the player in front. Shot from the point from Martin. Saved by Pegluka. Flashes the leather. Martin wanted that one. And beautiful sequence there from Fredonia, just hopping on the attack, but.
Yeah, it looked like it deflected in, but
right.
I think it deflected behind the net, and it looked like it was in from here.
I think Pegluka made the save into his own player, and it just bobbled around in front on the ground, and no one could bury it. But nonetheless, draw to the right of Pegluka here as Tracy wins it. McCabe at the point. McCabe fans on the shot, puts it down low, though.
20 seconds left on the 4-on-4.
Blitz has it now, puts it in low for Fredonia. Intercepted there by Leaf. Knocked out of the air by Blitz to the fans' enjoyment there as he saved probably a 2-on-1 there for Potsdam, but Potsdam collects behind their own net and the 4-on-4 is over. A minute to go on the penalty kill here for Fredonia. Potsdam still behind their own net. Now they break it out. Here comes Terranova. Up to Young breaking in. Along the half wall there. With Guimon. Guimon and Young working together down low. Farrell's in there with him, and Fredonia's on them. Terranova back to the point. Shot there, turned away by Rosen. Terranova has it back now. Terranova walking into the center, still has it, shoots, save, blocked away by Fredonia. Leith has it over to Terranova, over to Young. Young back to Leith. Leith with a shot. Shot wide.
20 Young seconds left.
Pressuring behind the net for Keeps. Puck went onto the back of the net, so the play is blown dead. But some words are being exchanged between Farrell and Fredonia. Once again, Farrell's been real chippy tonight with those Fredonia players.
17 seconds left on the Corakon Barley penalty.
You know he's going to come flying out of the box there. He's already up on his feet, ready to go. Draw to the left of Rosen after the puck went onto the back of the net. Out there to take it for Potsdam is MacArthur against Ryder. Ha, Mr. PA announcer, you were wrong. I was right.
So Ryder
out
the official
against MacArthur.
The official announcement.
Fredonia wins it and clears it all the way down. 14 seconds to go on the power play. That should do it for the penalty kill. Potsdam looking to hold behind their own net here with 5 seconds to go. And the Fredonia penalty kill stays perfect. 0-for-5 on the night for Potsdam, and that will result in an icing against Potsdam. So now Fredonia comes off the penalty kill and goes right on to the offensive attack with 6:35 to go here in the third period. 3-3 Fredonia-Potsdam.
Well, who wants it more?
Yeah, right.
Game's up for grabs.
Right.
Both teams fighting for the playoffs. Huge game. Pink the Rink, all the extra stuff in addition to hockey.
Right.
Who wants some more? Here we go.
Kirbis wins the draw. Tracy back to the point for Gamash. Gamash dumps it in down low. Kirbis in after it. Kirbis puts it up front. Cleared away by Potsdam. Gamash at the point. Over to his D partner at the point. Put a shot on net. Haynes clears away back to the point to Manley. Manley with a shot kicked away by Pegluka. Cleared out of the Potsdam zone. Gamash settles it down, but Potsdam takes it back. And Fredonia collects in their own zone, though. Tracy over to Manley. Manley up to Haynes. Haynes working along the half wall, behind into the corner. Haynes out in front for Tracy. Scores! Victor Tracy with a pass from Jacob Haynes makes it 4-3 Fredonia with 5:56 to go.
Well, the two leading scorers for Fredonia connect once again.
Yep.
Jacob Haynes finds Tracy for his second of the night, and it is 4-3 Fredonia.
A beautiful pass out of the zone there from Manley up to Haynes, and Haynes just spins around in the corner and finds Tracy in the middle. puts it on stick side. Pegluka again. Looks like they found his weak side.
All right, well, I said who wants some more?
Right.
So far, it's Fredonia. Under six to go now.
Tracy gets his sixth of the year, 24th in his collegiate career, and Fredonia wins it back into their own zone. Up to Dimakopoulos. Dimakopoulos tips it into the Potsdam zone. Kalou in to chase it. Broken up by Potsdam. Potsdam trying to clear it here. Back to McCabe, and McCabe selects at the neutral zone and dumps it in. Farrell has it now for Potsdam along his own bench. Farrell can't connect with Guimond. Guimond picks it up off the boards. Pestered there by Letmanski. Letmanski and Guimond and Young all going in after it. Richardson joins the scrum. So does Corcon Barley. Corcon Barley trying to get the puck away now. Guimond has it there. As he dumps it into the Fredonia zone, and it'll go out of play down into the corner. Wow. Very back and forth seesaw action tonight.
And 9 goals for the Blue Devils over the last 2 nights. So it's great to see their offense coming alive here.
Right. You
down
know
the stretch.
You know that they're not going down without a fight. If anything, they're going to play spoilers here for Potsdam. Mosh loses his stick, can't clear it out. Potsdam gets the puck back now. Worked along the point, shot, Rosen kicks it away. Cleared away by Fredonia. Here comes Whitman the other way. Whitman dumps it in low and chases after it. Whitman chasing in there with Venter. Venter leaves it for Winnicates. Worked up to Salau, but can't get to it. Haynes breaks it up. Haynes can't hold on to it. Now Salau, or Potsdam gets it back. Now over to Salau. Salau dumps it into Fredonia's zone. Rosen slows it down for Blitz, and Blitz will send it over to Manley. Manley's got pressure on him. Manley puts it up to Kirbitz. Kirbitz sends it along the boards to Tracy. Tracy into Haynes. Haynes can't dangle through. Clark has it behind his own net. Pops out in front. Fredonia gets it back. Gamache at the point. Can't put it down low. Kirbis gets it back now. Kirbis in the corner. Kirbis up to Gamache. Gamache almost loses it at the point there. Sends it back down low to Haynes. Haynes gets bodied into the corner by Cruikshank, and he's down in the corner still. As Cruikshank's holding him to the boards. I don't know how that's not some sort of call there, but Potsdam gets the puck back and clears it up the boards. Salau has it now with Zweig. And that'll go into the Fredonia bench, I believe.
And if you just heard the PA announcer, all the people who bought jerseys are going to be going down to ice level now.
I believe it's actually the families of that are on the backs of the jerseys, the families of the survivors or the victims of cancer.
Well, yeah, they're the ones that bought the jerseys.
Oh, well, right, yeah. You're right. My bad. But we ask you to stay tuned in the end after our post game. The Boxcast and the TV station will both have the jersey presentation after the game at center ice. Here comes Fredonia the other way now. Whitman breaking in, can't hold on to the puck as he has to just dump it down low, and Potsdam recollects. Young breaking up now for Potsdam into the Fredonia zone along the half wall. Takes a shot over Rosen's shoulder and high and wide. Kept in by Potsdam, but to no one in particular, and McCabe will collect behind his own net. Fredonia clears it all the way down, but not far enough for icing as Venter collects it in his own zone. Venter trying to do a stretch pass, can't connect. McCabe gets it now. Over to his D-man, or D-partner in Manley. Manley up to Letmanski. Letmanski with a shot, shot wide. Here comes Salau with speed up the right wing by the Fredonia bench. Drops it off for Terranova, and he's just offside.
2:59 remaining.
But yeah, as I was saying, we ask you to stay tuned on the Boxcast with the TV station, and you can watch the jersey presentation from Jeff Meredith and his players. It's always a cool sight to see, but that'll be after our post-game report in hopefully about 5 minutes. Fredonia wins the draw. Back to Blitz. Blitz dumps it in. Pegluka out to collect. Blitz has it in the neutral zone now. Sends it across. Dumped in there by Martin. Potsdam can't get anything going as they just cleared out to the neutral zone again, and Fredonia will re-dump it back in once again. Pegluka collects it now for Venter. Venter trying to get something going out of his own zone here. It's up to Winnicates. Winnicates can't connect with his man and Bloom. And They'll just have to dump it into the Fredonia zone. Manley's in to collect it. Here's Demakopoulos now. Gets it out of his own zone. Ooh, dumped back in by number 24, Machura.
Well, a little over 2 minutes left now. You got to wonder when the Bears are going to send Tugluka to the bench.
Broken up by Richardson. Richardson kind of trying to break in here with Machura. Machura dumps it into the front. Cleared away by Manley. Kept in at the point by Richardson. Richardson settles it down. Shot out in front. Goes wide to Rosen. Ooh, hook there on Manley. No call. Machura and Manley going at it behind the Fredonia net. Machura still has it. And that's Kalau now. Took over for Manley. Kalau's getting bodied in the corner with some sticks flying everywhere. Held in at the point by Richardson.
Minute and a half left.
Richardson puts it down low. Pagluka's still in his net. One of the players doesn't have a stick. I think that's Kalau. And they score!
Oh, man.
Farrell off the half wall. Sneaks it in underneath Rosen. Kalau didn't have a stick, and Peroni was dead tired at the end of their shift there.
Oh, man. That hit Kalau's, Tanner Kalau's stick.
Right, and it held it in.
As Fredonia tried clearing it, it held it in, and the Bears just snuck one right past Rosen as he wasn't even – I don't even think he saw that.
Nope. You know, it's a shame because, you know, refs are told if the play moves, go pick up the stick. And I'm not saying it's anybody's fault here, but, like, you know, come on. Go do your job. Haynes wins the draw for Fredonia, dumps it into the Potsdam zone. Potsdam trying to work it out here now. Held in by McCabe. Tracy in back behind the Potsdam net to pester Venter. Tracy has it now. Winnicates takes it back behind his own net up to Salau. Last minute of play in the third. Kept in by McCabe. Swings it down low once again. Venter has it now. Up to Salau. Held in by McCabe. Oh, can't hold it in that time as Haynes has to go back and he's pestered by Salau. Haynes up to McCabe. McCabe taken out along the boards. Gets the pass off anyway to Tracy. Tracy Cabra's shot. Bounces around in front. Pucks in the middle. And oh, Fredonia can't get a stick on it. Held in at the point by Martin. Martin shot blocked away by Terranova. Here comes Potsdam the other way on a breakaway. Here comes Farrell. Drops off to Clark. Clark shoots. Saved by Rosen. Kicked away.
Wow.
McCabe clears it away in the corner. Fredonia clears it out of their zone to neutralize. 20 seconds to go.
Tracy's dead.
Yeah, Tracy
He's at the
dead.
End of his shift.
Tracy gets off now, and it's cleared into the Potsdam zone. Clark and Lutmanski in after it. Cruikshank with him. Guarded along the boards is Salau and Cork and Barley. Lutmanski has it. Quick shot by Gamache. 1-0. We're going to overtime. 4-4 Fredonia Potsdam.
Oh, man. What a sequence of events. And Fredonia had a couple nice chances. Here, and the puck just was a couple inches away, deflected right up in the air.
Right. It's just a weird bounce. Those weird lucky bounces are what keeps teams in games or gets teams out of games. And we'll be back on in about 2 minutes here. But it's, wow, what a wild ride. Go from nothing at the end of the first to 1-1 and now 4-4. We saw 6 goals last period, and that was just insane, incredible show from both teams here, for all these fans here tonight for Pink the Rink night.
Hey, it's been back and forth all night. 0-0 after one, and then 1-1 after two, now 4-4.
And you look at the shot clock, and Fredonia hasn't even caught up. There's still 10 shots behind Potsdam, 38-28. And I mean, you got to look at Rosen, 34 saves on the night in his second game back, and last night he had a shutout. I mean, that is incredible for Anton Rosen, and you know, it's in Fredonia with 5 for 5 on the penalty kill. Did they score a power play goal? No, they did not. 0 for 3 on the power play. But what an incredible game we've had here for a special night. Pink the Rink night is. It's always a good show. Whether it's 1-0 or 6-5, you always get a good show on Pink the Rink night. We're about 45 seconds away here from puck drop. What are your thoughts here, Kev?
Just a great game. I mean, not to repeat, but it's really just been back and forth.
Right.
I think this was Fredonia's first lead of the night at 4-3, because I believe it was Potsdam
Potsdam all the way, yeah.
Would score, and then Fredonia would score. Potsdam, Fredonia. And then Fredonia gets that one to go up 4-3. Now Potsdam scores, and talk about a killer. It hits Kalu's stick, and, you know, again, I don't even think Rosenstahl went right between his legs and into the back of the net. So now we have
5-on-5 overtime for 5 minutes.
Come on, make it 3-on-3.
Young out there to take the draw against Kirbis. Young wins the draw back to his own zone.
And Tracy has two, so imagine if he can get a hat trick and a game winner here.
Here we go. We'll find out. Haynes with it now in his own zone along the half wall. Haynes trying to clear it up through. Richardson collects in his own zone. Richardson to Farrell. Haynes lays a body on Farrell. So does Tracy on Richardson. But Potsdam will recollect here. Broken up by Kirbis. Roney has in the neutral zone. Here comes Tracy now. Tracy breaking in. Tracy shoots and turned away by Pagluka.
What a nice stick move there from Tracy. I don't know how he got that through those. He got it through two defenders.
Broken up by Martin. Kept in at the point by Ryder. Down low is Dunner. And behind the Potsdam net. Dunner still in there. Trying to get it across the point to Martin. But they have to recollect out of the zone. Here comes Martin back in now. Martin shoots. Saved by Pagluka. 4:02 left in the overtime period. So all Fredonia so far right now. But got to be on your toes here in the overtime.
Good pressure here from Fredonia. A couple shots right away.
Young played that entire shift with one glove. He lost his glove at the beginning of the period in the Fredonia zone and couldn't go back and get it. So he played it with one glove the entire time. Terranova on the draw here against, I believe that's Corcombarley. Corcombarley wins it into the corner. Can't hang on to it, and Terranova gets it now. Terranova flips it up the boards. Lipmanski flips it back in. Winnicates has it now. Winnicates. Put it up the line, but Fredonia intercepts, and here's Manley. Sends it across to his partner, and here comes Lipmanski along his own bench. Lipmanski trying to break through. Can't get it. Potsdam recollects in their own corner. Out in front by Whitman. Whitman blocks it and can't hang on to it. Loses his footing. Dumped back in by McCabe. Pagluka out to collect it with Winnicates. Winnicates gets pressured there by Lipmanski. Claire has it behind his own net. Over to Winnicates. Winnicates to Terranova. Haynes intercepts. Back to McCabe. Here comes Kirbis now. Back to McCabe. Long lead pass up to Haynes. Haynes trying to break through. Can't get around his man. Fans really getting into it here tonight. Here's Blitz. Blitz dumps it far opposite corner. Kirbis to give chase along with Tracy. Kirbis and Tracy pressuring behind the Potsdam net. Tracy loses his footing and Potsdam gets the puck back. Here comes Thompson up the ice. Thompson. Centering pass. Shoots. Saved by Rosen.
Huge
on
save.
On front. Haynes clears away for Fredonia. Here comes Tracy the other way. Two on two. Tracy and Kalu. Martin joining the rush. Tracy shoots. Saved by Pagluka. Turned into the corner. Potsdam trying to clear out of their own zone. Can't do it. Tracy takes a high stick to the face. No one saw it, and he gets off the ice. Ryder dumps it in. Chases after it. He's in there with Cruikshank. Ryder lays the body on Cruikshank. Gets the puck back. Dunner has it now, trying to break free. Dunner can't do it. MacArthur clears it out of the Potsdam zone. MacArthur dumps it in the Fredonia zone. Look out, right in the front. Puck clears out over the glass.
Well, 1:56 left in the overtime. A reminder, there is no shootout in college. So
stupid.
If no one scores, we have ourselves a tie game, and that is
those.
It.
I hate tie games.
I know.
I hate it.
I don't know why they can't just do a shootout. Do it like the NHL. 2 points for the winner, 1 point for the loser.
Here comes Richardson now, dumps it in, and goes to the right of Rosen. Fredonia collects it here. Looked up to Lipmanski. Lipmanski bricked it to the neutral zone. Fredonia working in along the half wall. Down low to Corcombarley. Corcombarley rings it around the boards to McCabe. McCabe at the point. McCabe sends it back down around the boards. Fredonia and Potsdam battling in the corner to the left or to the right of Pagluka. Shot on by Corcombarley. Deflects off a stick up into the netting. So it'll stay in the Potsdam zone with 1:28 to go in the overtime period.
There are a lot of little kids here tonight. They're really into it.
Yeah. Shot clock is closing a little bit. Fredonia's within 10. 31-39 shots in favor of Potsdam. Draw to the right of Pagluka here with Gearbus on the draw. Gearbus wins it. Haynes can't get his stick on it. Cleared out by Potsdam. But Fredonia is trying to bring it right back in here. Here comes Kirbis through the neutral zone, trying to find an open. Can't get past Salau. Salau breaks it up, can't get past Manley. And here comes Victor Tracy the other way. Victor Tracy over to Haynes. Haynes too far behind him. Haynes picks it up at the point. Swings it down low to Martin. Last minute of play in the game. Here comes Martin behind his own, behind the Potsdam net. Gets taken down. Held in at the point to Haynes. And Haynes can't get it across to Martin. It's broken, or Manley, it's broken up. Manley puts it back out. And the VFSU chant.
Now the crowd's
started.
Into it.
Yeah, crowd
where was this
is really
all game?
Swung up the boards to MacArthur. MacArthur passes it back to his D-man. Over to Salau. Fredonia breaks it up. Fredonia trying to clear, and Salau will have to get out as he's offside, but he clears it right back into the Fredonia zone.
One last push here. 25 seconds left.
Here comes Blitz the other way. Blitz has the puck. Swings it out in front. Oh, cleared away out of the front of the net by Potsdam.
15 seconds.
Blitz puts it back down low. Broken up by Potsdam. Potsdam in on a two-on-one. Here comes Benz. Here comes Benzica. Benzica puts it behind the net. 7 seconds to go. Kalou trying to clear it up the ice. Gets the neutral zone, and that will be the game. Whew. Fredonia goes to overtime once again, and it ends in a tie. 4-4. Potsdam Fredonia on Pink the Rink night. Wow. What a game.
Man, you know, you get a point out of it, which is great, but
right.
At the same time, it's very deflating.
Very deflating. I'll pass the mic off here to Trevor for Trevor and Kevin's postgame show. Thank you for listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia. I've been Josh Schmidt. Alongside me, as always, Kevin Syracuse and Trevor Hauer. Stay tuned for the postgame show. You've been listening to Hockey Night in Fredonia on WDVL 89.5 The Inferno and 88.9 The Voice. Stay tuned.
Well, Trevor, that was very exciting compared to that first period.
Very exciting.
Back and forth we went, but in the end, unfortunately, Fredonia is unable to hang on to their lead. But
yep.
On the bright side, they didn't give up another goal in overtime. So when it's all said and done, we finished in a tie here.
I liked that it was a tie instead of a loss. A tie is obviously way better than a loss. But for these Fred boys, I don't know, is 4-3 giving up that 4-3 lead, does it feel like a loss to them, do you think?
If that was me, I would kind of feel so. You know, you fight back all game, and then you finally take the lead thanks to Victor Tracy's goal. And then as Victor Tracy is announced as the player of the game. But, you know, you go up 4-3, and then it's, you know, just a crushing blow to have that one go in. And like Josh and I were saying, that hit Tanner Kalu's stick. So it wasn't even like a real clean goal, I would say, because Fredonia is trying to clear it out. It hit the
yep.
stick, stayed in the zone. And then they, I don't even remember who put the shot on for Potsdam, but he slid it right past Rosen. I don't even think Rosen saw it was coming.
Yeah, I think Potsdam would.
I think it was Farrell.
Bryce
Farrell. He was the one. He was pestering the Blue Devils all night, so that makes it even worse.
I mean, especially down by a goal during crunch time, Potsdam would take it any way they can get them, and maybe a little tap off the stick, but it ended up in the back of the net anyway. And, I mean, in the third period, there were a total of 6 goals with both teams. If that's not entertaining, I really don't know what is, especially at this level.
Yes, very entertaining for sure.
And the funny thing was, after the first period, we were talking about a boring 0-0 game. After the third and overtime, 4-4, you couldn't have asked for a better game for you guys to commentate and for me to just to watch and take stats on. But, I think Fredonia, honestly, they might feel a little bad about not coming away with the win in this one. But they should be fine with a tie, especially in front of their home fans.
Yeah, that's the main thing. You know, they didn't lose, but at the same time, they didn't win. And that was symbolic of the whole game.
Yes.
You know, when in the first period when I said there wasn't a lot of energy. It was pretty, like, a mediocre game.
Yep.
Both teams are playing mediocre. Then both teams picked it up in the second, 1-1. And then both teams really picked it up in the third. And then they each scored 3 goals, and it finished at 4-4. So I think that's pretty fitting for the type of game that it was.
Definitely. And for Fred to come away with a point in this one and a big win last night, I think they should be okay with this. I don't really know what was said in the locker room to have this kind of spark, but it was obviously something inspiring from both teams. 0-0 after one, 4-4 after OT. You know, unfortunately, we can't go to another overtime or a shootout, but very entertaining game to watch, and probably for you to call with Josh.
Yeah, for sure. So Victor Tracy had 2 goals, Tommy Martin 1, and Bryce Whitman had 1. And then assist, Jacob Haynes had 2.
Yep.
Matt Lemansky had 1. Jasper Cork and Barley had 1. And Tyler Ryder had 1.
Cork and Barley's going on a little point streak now. I think, I believe in the 5-5 tie game, he got 5 assists or something like that. And then he scored 2 last night.
Yeah, he had 2 goals last night and
an
assist.
An assist tonight, so.
So I think that will do it as the Blue Devils are having their jersey ceremony here. If you've been listening, thank you. And if you've been watching, thank you. And you can continue to watch on the Fredonia Boxcast on the Blue Devils website. So we will be done for tonight, but you can watch the rest of the ceremony on the Boxcast. Coming up on Fredonia Radio, we have, let's see, next week, next Saturday, hockey, senior night versus Geneseo, a huge game for Fredonia. I believe basketball is home next weekend, too.
Yes,
so
they are. Yep.
We're going to have some basketball games and a hockey game next week.
Geneseo is going to be a tough task, but by the way Fredonia's been playing over the past 3 games, I believe they can do it. They can at least tie.
So with that, Fredonia drops to 5-9-7. So 7 ties now. Just that shows how close they've been in these games. So they are 5-9-7, and once again, they are at Brockport next Friday, home against Geneseo on Saturday for senior night, and then they finish the season
on a little road trip
at Cortland and at Oswego on the 21st and 22nd. So that will do it here for Fredonia Radio. I'm Kevin Syracuse
and
with
Trevor Hauer,
Josh Schmidt. He already said his goodbyes, and thank you for listening, watching, whichever way you did. And have a good rest of your weekend.